Hello, I'm live now.
Yeah.
Welcome in, everyone. I'll restart. Ready? 3, 2, 1. Yo, what the heck is going on, everybody? It's your boy, Snowbike Mike, back at it again on another lovely Wednesday afternoon for another Kind of Funny Games afternoon stream. It's Mike and the big dog, Kevin Coelho.
Oh, oh, oh,
he's back right on time. Barrett is running and gunning shows today, so he ran away. But Kevin showed up right on time and, like, we're here, Kev. You know what I mean? Like, the crew is all here. We're chilling. We got bagels outside. When you're ready to get a bagel, Kevin, you treat yourself, all right? Tell me, Brody. Tell me, Brody.
And there it is.
Turn his mic
there
up.
There it is. There it is. Oh, but I can't hear it.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I can't hear it.
Hold up. Hold
all right,
up.
All right. There I am. There I am. There I am. I can hear it. God, I wish I was here 5 minutes early. You know what I mean?
Oh,
this would have made it so much better.
It's okay. Hey, we're here. We're easing into it because it's the finale of Final Fantasy VII Remake. That is the goal today. We are going to play all the way through the finale of Final Fantasy VII. We're going to experience this together, and I hear it's really freaking good. Andy will be joining us. As you know, he's just getting off of Games Daily, so I'm sure everyone's kind of in motion right now, and that's why I'm trying to bring a little ease into your life.
Ease.
We're easing into it, y'all. Into it, okay? And so we're going to have some fun. We're going to enjoy each other's company. Kevin's going to get a bagel for sure.
I'm going to double check real quick that Barrett doesn't need anything.
Go do that. Go do that. Let me handle it. Okay, go do that. I'll talk with the chat. Chat, now that everybody's gone and we can just ease into this. Hey, happy Wednesday. I hope you all are doing so well. It is great to see you. I saw some of you very early in the morning. If you tuned into that stream, thanks for watching. Thanks for hanging out. If you have been watching Games Daily, where they went over the Nintendo Direct, and they had a second part two of the Games Daily, where Andy and Bless, our resident From Software super fans, talked all about Elden Ring, Shadow of the Erdtree.
Bro, tell me about that trailer. Was it good? Was it everything
bananas,
you wanted it to be?
Kevin, I have no idea anything that's happening,
yeah,
but I smiled. You know what I mean? I smiled the whole time.
Mike,
tell me.
Oh,
tell me, Andy.
Hold on.
Tell
this
me,
is
Andy.
The wrong window. Hold on.
Tell me.
Yeah, so, you know, we...
Wait, Andy. Hold on.
Oh, I'm
Mike
sorry.
Is down. And there you go. You can talk now.
Okay, you can talk.
And let me get the camera. I don't know what...
Cody Rhodes, finish the story, Mike.
We're about to finish.
we're about to finish
some story.
About to finish the fucking story. So, yeah, unfortunately, we have something else that's about to be recorded out there,
yeah,
so we couldn't... go even talk about the Miyazaki stuff about Bloodborne. You know?
Oh, you felt. Oh shit.
Yeah.
He left a lot on the table.
Well, yeah,
a lot of conversation.
Yeah, because
sure,
Miyazaki ended up talking about Bloodborne as well, and I was like, hey, we love the fans, love this game, and it's like, cool. Well, what else? You know, anything else you got there? No, man. But this shit's about to be insane.
What'd you think? So, how big is Limgrave? Because I forget. Is that the first area?
Yeah, Limgrave.
So that's a pretty large, like, mini continent, right?
Yeah, Limgrave. Limgrave is a decent amount. I gotta assume it's gonna be more packed, more littered.
Okay.
Now I am wondering, are there gonna be above and underground elements to Limgrave
okay,
to
yeah,
expand? Because again, if it's the size of Limgrave,
it's not super big, but it's big. Because I'm thinking, will it encompass the south below Limgrave? Does it encompass the rotting area?
Well, you know, no, I mean? No.
I know it's two different sections, but how big is big?
So, like, I think one thing that takes up a lot of space is the ride up to Godric's castle.
Yeah, uh-huh.
And so...
Well, you can't forget, you got those offshoots, too, where we fought the bats underneath the bridge.
Yeah.
We fought that one dude who turns into a goblin at night who got real mad at Nick, remember?
Oh, yeah, the red guy. The one that Nick got real mad at.
Remember, if you keep following that, there's a super bridge that you can jump off of, and that's where we met.
Yeah.
Tomato Man or Man in the Bucket Man, right? The Bucket Man.
The head? The helmet?
No, I think it was the Bucket Guy who was stuck, right? The big guy, the pot guy.
The
first time.
Yeah.
He's like, I need help, and we pulled his ass out of it.
Yeah.
Oh, he was Winnie the Poohing.
What's his fucking... Alexander, yeah, Alexander.
Alexander, yeah.
Yeah, so I don't know, man. I got to watch that thing again. It was kind of... The audio is a little bit tougher to discern out there, and unfortunately, the subtitles are YouTube generated.
Oh,
they didn't provide subtitles.
Okay.
So, like, whenever the male figure was talking at the end, which I assume was Mikala,
I think it's Mesmer. I believe that's this person's name, because in the Miyazaki interview, that's the main baggie. That's a dude, and his name is Mesmer.
With the snakes?
M-A-R.
Oh, what?
How you spell that. Yeah, something like that.
Of course they had to go with another M name.
Yeah, correct me with that. Yeah,
you gotta Mesmer, go with another M name.
Bro.
Holy shit.
Yeah. And then when they both hit the wings at the end, it's like, oh, get the fuck out of here.
Shit.
Get the fuck out of here.
Man, I'm about to go to church. Oh, my God.
Are you kidding me?
It's incredible. Incredible.
That crazy hippo thing that turned into a Pokemon?
So Brain says, I think it's a third sibling, which is very fascinating because this whole time we've known that there are three kids of Radagon who turned into Merica and fucked himself.
Whoa.
So he's like a man and a woman. He's Radagon and Merica.
Okay.
There's a big reveal where like there's a big statue of Radagon.
Yeah.
Of Merica, and then you do some magic spell and the statue turns to Radagon. You're like, oh fuck, they're the same person.
The Shrine of Merica's? That's what we're talking.
Yeah. So check.
Get the fuck out of
here. Yeah, the Stakes of Merica. So another tidbit I told the Blessing out there when we fought Renala, the lady with the big moon with the baby.
Uh huh.
She has a little BB from Death Stranding.
Uh huh.
There are no Stakes of Merica anywhere in that area to get back to the boss. Usually when you die to a boss, it's like, respawn at the Stake of America.
It's close.
You can't do that because Radagon used to be married to Renala, divorced her. And she was like, get the fuck out of here. Get out of my school. Get out of my Harry Potter school. So there are no Stakes of America there because he's the same person. He's like, fuck that. I don't want to help anybody out here. You know what I mean? So it's really, really wild shit. But there's always been three kids. Melania.
Who is
Scarlet Rot.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
She's all fucked up. Why is she all fucked up? Because her dad basically fucked himself. Incest.
Okay.
It's like an incestual thing. That's why she's all weird. And she, you know, the Scarlet Rot made her blind and all this messed up stuff.
Yeah.
Mikola, who can never grow to be an adult, always like eternally a child.
Which one does she look like?
Well,
she's not Remy the Blue Lady, right?
No, that's Ronnie.
Ronnie, not Remy.
Remy
is from Ratatouille. Mikola's hand is hanging out of the big egg when we fought Moog. The blood god guy.
That's crazy.
So that's Mikola's hand. There's always been thought to be a third child.
Oh.
Because there's some items you could pick up, and it's like... it's like a butterfly fucking... There's like three items, and one of the butterfly things represents Melania, one of the butterfly things represents Mikola, and there's always been a third butterfly thing. And everybody assumed it was Melina, the girl who would see you at the... Close one eye, show up at the little bonfires or whatever.
To be my dream.
Everybody thought it was Melina. She's the third child, probably. Starts with an M. We don't really know the lineage, but now we know that it's got to be this Mesmer.
Mesmer.
It's a fucking Mesmer, dude.
Got a snake, too.
Messy.
Messy, fucking messy, bro.
Fuck.
Said Nuggies had the best one. I'm mesmerized.
Dude, like, me too.
Yeah.
Me, fuck, anyone could cook Ludacris.
Oh, my God.
Holy shit.
So that shit's crazy. And, like, there was some cool stuff there. When he was pulling that thing out of his forehead, that was sick. Fucking the guy on the tiny horse
throat
again.
Goatin'.
We doing the tiny horse again?
I didn't see a tiny horse.
It was like this skeleton that was riding a horse and he like whipped the bone boomerang at
you.
But he had like a little tiny dead horse underneath him again. You know
shit, I didn't even realize that.
And then there was a weird like bear dog thing that could be a man though, because like a lot of bottom halves turn out to be dude's feet. It's very weird. Very weird.
What that reminded me of, when you fight Godfrey, and Godfrey turns into his other form, where he's basically just a Street Fighter character, and he has like this lion over him named Sirash.
Okay,
and he like kills the lion. I thought that lion was that that guy.
Could be that guy.
Horalu, thank you, little Jacob.
Okay,
Horalu Warren. He used to be named Horalu when he was like a part of a tribe, and then he became Godfrey. Whatever. God damn, bro.
This shit's so cool.
I gotta put down my microphone and go get my water real quick.
Are we ever going back?
We're going back.
Well, yeah, we're going back for the DLC.
We gotta go back, bro. We got it.
It's gonna be an absolute shit show.
DLC take place in the lore?
So apparently you're going to the past.
Going to the past, but what is the past?
But in order to go to the past, we have to fight a boss that we haven't fought yet. I don't think me.
Oh.
Wait, have you, me, and Nick fought Moog? You, me, and Kevin did. Kevin Ace.
We fought Moog?
Yeah.
What does he look like?
He's got like the horns. He would put the blood curse on you, and then you would have to, he'd count down, and take your, you know, that guy.
Remember that? That's
so that's where, so that's where the big egg is, and Mikla's hand is sticking out of, and then you walk up to the hand, and the DLC will be started when you touch Mikla's hand, and you get transported to the past or some shit.
Okay.
You get a little.
Is it a strong hand?
It's a dead looking hand.
Yeah,
because
like it's kind of like weird.
It's.
It was a reference to a movie.
Take my strong hand. Yeah. Scary movie.
Yeah.
I gotta get my water real quick.
Hand. Remember when he puts it in the pumpkin pie?
Yep.
I never forget that, man. Put it in the pumpkin pie. So, chat, yeah, clearly we're coming hot off of the Elden Ring Shadow of the Erdtree Tree. It's very exciting. IGN has a great interview with Miyazaki that will give you even more details if you're into it. I saw a friend of mine, Jess, from Bethesda. She put out a crazy, like, you know, like lore predictions or like guessing type stuff. I was like, oh shit, Andy would eat this up because there's a bunch of insane shit out there,
who
bro.
Was that?
Jess from Bethesda. I'll find her right now. Shit was crazy. It's like, Kevin, they be talking about this stuff, and I'm like, I don't know what this means.
You know what I mean?
You know what I mean? You should have saw me reacting to it. I just said, oh, that's sick. Who's that person?
If I wanted to, can I?
What?
So you're reacting to it?
Oh, yeah. I mean, you know what I'd like to react to, Kevin, if we could. I'll throw it at you, if we could.
I mean,
I would like to react to the Borderlands trailer. I have not seen it yet. We kind of played it already on Games Daily, but I would love to react to the Borderlands trailer. I know not it's not as exciting, people, but like...
Are you kidding?
I would love to watch the Borderlands trailer.
I bet you Andy's excited. Yeah, it, like always, hearing it is going to be a problem.
That's my problem. Well, you see, I put it over there, but I don't think it's right. I don't know how to do it.
Yeah, it doesn't work like that as much as I wish it did.
And so, like, this is Jess right here. And she's got a whole, like... idea of what's going on with this jabroni. Like, yeah, you should read through that. It's a real good thing. And I'll keep
talking. All right, I'm just gonna look her up.
Look it up.
Jess Capade.
Yo, come on, man. So hype. And June? And
crazy.
I need you to do me one favor.
What's up?
I know you get first dibsies on the statue, but I'm gonna need you to get 2 steps. Okay, because I want one. I need everyone out there.
Kevin, can you bring up what the collector's edition is? Because I didn't even get a look at it. I was trying to collect my 40 thoughts.
40-page hard-covered art book.
Oh, man, I love an art book.
And a big statue of Mesmer.
Oh, I'm fucking Mesmer.
So sick. Yo, if you're out there from Software, Andy always gets first dibs. But think about 2.
Second dibs.
Second dibs. But then Blessing might be there, so maybe 3. Maybe 3. Yeah. Throwing it out there, you know what I mean? Just think about it. Because I need that. I need that real bad. Yeah, bring that up. We'll show it to everybody. And, yeah, dude, this thing is sick. I don't know if you'll be able to see it from there. Well, I guess, like, you can kind of see it, but, like, it won't go up on the screen.
Oh, yeah, okay.
He can't be pulling.
Hold on. I mean, we can switch stuff around if you just give me a minute.
Oh, Kevin can do that. Kevin can do
so
that.
So let me read this real quick.
Calm down. I don't like the attitude you got going on.
I missed you. We just missed you today. That's why.
Jess Capade, who is this person that Mike talked about from Bethesda.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
Jess_Capade on Twitter.
Yeah.
GameStream.
Says, a few Elden Ring Shadow of the Erdtree 3 lore thoughts. Spoilers if you're worried about the story. This massive Sarosh-like puppet wielded by what I can only assume is a Morgott-like character. Yeah, because Morgott who was Margit the Fell.
Yes.
Just like Moog. All those people are cursed, so they have like the horns going out of them. And those are like looked down on by society. Yeah. Everybody hates, they're like, oh, you're a fucking freak, get out of here. Yeah. So we could see horns here. A Morgott-like character has fascinating lore implications of the shadow reflection dream world created by Mikla. Morgott, loyal to the Golden Order, was always jealous of the non-omen. They're called omens, by the way. Margit the Fell Omen, you know?
Oh, yeah, that was
Margit the Fell. In the Shadow World, they wield a crafted mockery of the Beast Companions bestowed to chosen Empyreans. So, like, Ronnie's an Empyrean.
So is
Mikla and Melania. Mikla was famously kind to the misbegotten Omen born. Oh, so Mikla was super chill with, like, the misbegottens and the omens. Like, hey, I know y'all are ugly. Everybody hates you.
Yeah.
I think you're kind of chill.
But I'm here. I'm
yeah.
here.
Uh-huh. That's like why that. We're seeing such a... What a resounding endorsement. I'm here.
I'm here too. You know?
I'm here with you. this is why we're seeing such prominent beast figures all over this new inclusive world Mikla seems to be influencing. I don't think it's coincidence that the first shot we see is Mesmer is their right hand. I think this is a manifestation of Mikla if he could age. Because again, Mikla was always cursed to be a little child, a little baby.
Oh, shit.
Wouldn't he look similar to this long red-haired twin? Again, Mikla had blonde hair. Which was Merica's blonde hair. Mm. Mesmer has red hair. Radagon's red hair.
Oh!
Radagon fucked himself. wearing armor very reminiscent of a clean Rot set. Normally, I think Rykard with all the snake motifs, but what if it's symbolic of Mikula's support of the Misbegotten? I also think of the snake Ouroboros, which fits Mikula's theme. If Merica and Radagon could manifest in two parts, why couldn't Mikula? Holy shit.
Just
if Radagon could fuck himself, why can't Mikula and Mesmer become two boys and fuck themselves? Stop. Holy shit.
Stop it, people.
Oh!
We're going deep into the lore.
Evil twin? This is crazy.
Got crazy shit going on. Let's show Andy this collector's edition here in just a second as Kevin sets it up. Man, oh man. What a day.
Oh my God.
Great start to the day.
Oh my God.
We got this and Borderlands.
Wait, did that just change on its own?
It just changed. It just changed.
It did, yeah.
Why did it do that?
I can see it from here.
Wait, no, all right. Hey, calm down, all right?
Yeah, he's gonna give you the best. Kevin always will give you the best. Because I told you. You can see it just fine.
Oh, there we go.
Also, you being able to see it has never been the problem. Just so you know.
Look at this, bro. Are
look
you
at
kidding
Mesmer.
Me? What's 46 centimeters? Can I get a size?
Oh, man.
Hold on. Let me guess.
Right, go ahead.
Okay, take a guess.
That can't be right.
8 inches.
Oh, okay, 46. 8 inches from you. I'm going to take a guess as well. 46.
12 inches.
12? You think a foot? You think a foot on
guys,
that?
Guys, 2.3 divided by 46. It's easy.
Is it?
20.
20 inches?
He's
so.
Bigger than Venom?
No way!
He's bigger than Venom?
I mean, I did some quick math. Give me a second.
Okay. Hold up.
That's massive. So, like, the Melania figure that I got was around
19,
there.
18.
Whoa, wow, that's a big Mesmer.
That's some pretty quick math on my
that's
end.
That's a big Mesmer.
Not that far off. Uh-huh.
Pretty good, Kevin.
Not thank bad, you.
Kevin.
Look at how hot that is, bro. Are you kidding
man.
Me? That red pops, dude. That looks good.
Yeah, that red looks super sick. Oh, man.
40-page hardcover art book? Come on, that's
these,
so you.
These snakes got fucking, like, wings growing out of them.
He's got snakes on his helmet that aren't real snakes, but they're snakes on his helmet, bro.
You think they're jealous of the ones that are real?
That are alive? Yeah,
I like, wish that could be me.
He only chose those ones. He's got wings all over the place?
Yeah.
This guy's cool, bro.
Oh.
This is going to be cool.
Goodness gracious.
Oh, my gosh. So we had a lot of fun. Of course, you can see Andy's live reaction over on Games Daily Part 2 because we have two Games Dailies today, one covering the Nintendo Direct and one blessing Eddie Oye Jr. and Andy Cortez live reacting to this for the first time. They talked about it. We just went even more in depth, which I'm very happy about.
Very cool. Very cool stuff.
And so now, to keep the theme of the day going, which is, oh, wow, what an awesome day, 3 of 4 things we're checking off the list. Number 3 is a live reaction to the Borderlands trailer. Now, as many of you know, I love Kevin Hart.
You love Kevin
Hart. I love Kevin Hart.
You are there day one.
I thought he was going to say me, if I'm being totally honest.
I love Kevin.
Because, like, I set it up. I thought he was going to be like...
I love Kevin for setting this up.
real quick, a gunshot's just happened. Did you guys hear it on that screen?
Yes.
I did hear a soft one. Yeah.
Yeah.
So now... Andy, on your little iPad right now, can you bring up, like, the posters they've been showing from Borderlands? Because they're going to have, like, you know, Jamie Lee Curtis is in this. There's going to be some jabronis that you and I have to talk about because I don't quite know what the move here. Oh, yeah, that's, if you click on that, I think it's a whole thread of, like, jabronis. And, yeah, we'll just go right up
Kate
and down,
Blanchett,
right?
Kate Jack Blanchett, Jack Black.
Who is she? Who did she do?
She's a Hela in Thor Ragnarok.
Oh,
she
shit! Does, yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah, she was good in that.
Yeah,
she was good
awesome,
in that. Okay,
yeah.
What else we got?
She was Galadriel in Lord of the Rings.
Oh.
Come on,
we love that movie, bro.
She went to Antarctica in that one art movie.
Galadriel.
No.
Art movie.
No, I don't know that one.
I knew you guys wouldn't know it, that's why I said.
An art movie? Like an art?
Who's Claptrap? That's
Jack
an important
Black.
Piece. Get out of town, it's Jack. This are is, we just making Jumanji?
This is you.
Little Rock.
Yeah, The Rock is Tiny Tina. No, Tiny Tina's a little girl from Barbie, who's like the daughter of America Ferrera.
No, I missed that. So, like, on Barbie, I only got.
Did you fall asleep during
she
it?
She got in the car and she started driving.
Watch
and I fell
didn't
asleep.
Want to support it.
You know what I mean? I missed it. She got in the car and Ryan woke up and he was like, "I'm in the car too because I don't ever want to leave you, Barbie." And then I fell asleep.
Did you watch Madam Web?
No, I haven't watched.
You fall asleep in the theater?
No, on my phone. I was watching on my phone.
Gotcha.
On
okay.
TikTok.
Of course.
So I couldn't rewind.
I don't know who Krieg is, and I don't know who Florian Montanue is.
That's Krieg. Okay, Krieg is like...
It's one of the psychos.
Yeah, like, one of the psychos.
Isn't Florian the psycho?
Florian Montanue. I don't know that name.
Muscular person.
I don't know that name. Okay, next one.
Dr. Tanis is Jamie Lee Curtis.
Of course. That's a big pull right there.
Roland, Kevin Hart.
I'm excited about it. Not many people pleased about that one, but I'll tell you what, I like it. Star power.
Yeah, Roland was a lot larger.
Yes, he was. He was very, very interesting.
Okay.
Let's run this and let's see if it's any good. Because a lot of people say this is going to be real bad.
Yeah.
We're going to find out.
Well, okay. Yeah, let's see.
You know what I mean? It should just be fun. That's the goal.
All right, ready?
Yeah.
But also, it's going to be bad.
Her web connects them all.
Oh, wait. Why are we not...
I hate these little pre-things. Yeah, guns. I know I'm watching a trailer.
Why are we pre into the trailer? Just show it.
Look at that! A ladder! Unfortunately, design doesn't facilitate this type of...
He does sound like Jack Black.
Well... Does he?
Destiny awaits.
He's something good at that.
He's good, bro.
Has it that there's this massive treasure hidden in some secret vault. And if you go hunting for it, you'd better take any help you can get.
Pap-tai looks good.
Yo!
The weirdest, most dangerous dumpster fire of a world in the universe.
God, I hate this planet.
Why does this look good so far?
What is that smell? Hold on. Bad taste.
Ew!
Put the window up.
I don't want to.
Roll the window up.
It's pee. It's pee. Why do you think it's called piss wash? How did it get the name?
It's in my mouth.
That's kind of good.
You might want to get ready, ladies and gentlemen. This is gonna be good.
Was that kind of good?
Bobby Lee.
Bobby Lee is in this.
Looking for this vault?
We have something they don't, baby girl.
Okay.
What?
Major issues.
Time to make it rain! With your body parts!
What did I tell you?
Minimal explosions!
I said no explosions!
Come on! She looks good as Lilith, too. Kevin Hart.
It's Kevin Hart. Kevin Hart as Kevin Hart.
Ooh, mine's bigger.
What are you doing?
I needed a gun.
So you asked for it.
Will Handsome Jack show up?
There's only one of you in the world, and you're special.
Uh-oh.
Kill them all.
Unless that's him?
No.
They got Moxie. Moxie was in this.
Oh, yeah. Come on.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Come on.
You aren't giving a thumbs up.
Oh, hold on. He's shitting
right now.
I'm expelling the excess lead. I can't go if you're looking at me. Actually, scrap that.
He was shitting.
I can. I really can. Actually, it's helping.
Are we really ready for this to finish?
Keep looking at me.
Hey, Jack Black doing it like... Hey.
Hold up. Hold up. If you're not smiling right now, bro.
We have an Oscar winner on our hands here, man.
We got something.
We got a contender
going on in that one right now.
I like that Jack Black is not doing just Jack Black.
Okay. Yeah, yeah.
You could tell it's Jack Black, but he's trying to put on a character.
Yes.
You can tell he like watched a lot of clips of gameplay.
Okay.
I know his kids are gamers, so maybe they also experienced Claptrap in gaming form. That was exciting. That was cool.
That was much better than I thought it was going to be. Yeah. I thought we were going to walk away going, shaking our heads going, that was really bad. That was fun. And
I thought this was going to be Twisted Metal levels of the trailer.
Oh, my God.
I don't think it was far off.
Oh, really? Oh, I'm way different.
Really? Oh, my God.
I thought that trailer was...
I thought it was fun. I thought the look was good. But a lot of the humor is like, that reminded me a lot of like...
playing Borderlands.
Well, yeah, no. Borderlands humor.
The humor remind, like the back and forth and the way it was cut, like reminds me of like, what's that one movie where they're on a road, Are We There Yet?
With Ice Cube?
Yeah, I never watched the movie. I just watched the trailer a million times.
Yeah.
And it's just like a lot of those same... Yeah.
Did they get
there? Made more than
were they there yet?
I think it's one of those that are we still...
Are we still there yet?
Yeah, shit like that. Are we almost there?
I thought that was way more impressive than I thought it was going to be.
Way better.
I still don't think it's going to be amazing, but I'm going to get a couple laughs, a couple of goofs.
We're going to go get some popcorn and go to this. Let's just say this. Before you saw Madam Web, if you went out the Madam Web trailer and that, Which one would you say, Mike, I'd like to go to a Friday night movie?
100% love Adam Webb. Yeah.
That's Adam crazy,
Webb. But that's,
bro.
you're comparing a shitty meal to just poop. Just, you know?
Okay, just okay. Poop. Just poop, he's gone.
I'm waiting for Kevin to be silenced on this.
Yeah. What?
You're going to become a massive Borderlands movie
what
fan.
What if?
I would hope so. But there's just a couple things on, like, the timing of stuff of, like, why didn't the explosion on that giant worm thing should have happened before and they would have just gone through instead of there being that, like, moment of, like, what's going to happen? It's like, it's clearly what they're setting up. Just, like, it would be funnier that way. But anyways, doesn't matter. Like, I just already feel like the humor is not... It's not catering to me.
I mean, the thing that makes me think the humor will hit in a lot of different ways was them fucking getting piss all over them.
That
level of we're going to kind of like shock you in a way while still trying to be funny. Oh, it's in my mouth. Like,
yeah.
I wasn't expecting that level of stuff, which I probably should have because it is Borderlands. And Borderlands, I probably laughed at like 20 to 30% of whenever I would play that game.
Of course.
And you would cringe the rest of the time. This seems kind of promising. I'm excited to watch Kevin Hart.
I love when Kevin does like when he tries to act tough. There's like a Kevin Hart like classic he always does where it's like, all right, everybody, we're gonna. And you're like, it doesn't play like that.
Yeah.
Kevin. It just doesn't play like that. But I'll watch you do it every time because I love it. All right, so that completes three of the four super exciting things that we are doing today. Nintendo Direct covered, Elden Ring Shadow of the Erdtree covered, Borderlands trailer covered. That means we go to number four. And you know what number four is, Andy?
What?
This right
here. Oh my God.
Here. It is the finale of Final Fantasy VII Remake. It's my first time ever playing. I've got to ride alongside you in the chat the whole time, Andy. And we're building up to get to Final Fantasy Rebirth, where I will play it on launch day with everybody. I'm excited. Like, this is going to be a really good time. Andy, there's been a lot going on here. And I'm going to need your help. I'm going to need the chat's help because we have taken a little bit of time off and we've gotten into a weird part here. Because you weren't here.
Yeah.
A lot of people said, take the stairs, Mike. And they burned me.
They burned me. So we don't trust them.
They burned me real good.
They burned me too.
Okay. Should I have taken the elevator?
100%.
Yes.
I'm glad you took the stairs. That's good cardio.
It's great cardio.
It's so
great. Great on the thighs.
I miss when I
used to. We looked at the chat. We looked at them right in the eyes. And we were like, for reals? And you know what they did? They looked at us back and they were like, yeah. Uh-huh.
That's what they looked
like. For reals?
I thought maybe it would be like seven staircases. We laugh. It's a little humorous.
Yeah.
And then they fast forward.
It was 15 minutes. Barrett ran over and made him do it. And I was like, oh, thank God for Barrett.
Yeah, yeah.
You know? And I was wrong.
Yeah.
He was wrong. And I was right.
That's why you don't have Barrett on content. We all know that.
Barrett.
He's going to try to screw you all.
He's going to try to screw you.
He's going to try to screw you all. Also, man, he's messing up the Wi-Fi at home.
What's up with that, man?
Kevin, what's he doing?
Kevin, I need you to get a mesh network over here, okay?
How many times did I tell you? It's so easy.
You've
so
never
easy.
Offered, and it's like, finally, I got to beg you.
Well, what do you mean?
You know what? You know what? Me and Kevin have offered. We'll come to your house, redo your room. Your
I don't want you anywhere near my electronics.
Your whole room.
I don't want you anywhere near my electronics.
We'll get it wired right.
Kevin will touch it.
I'll never forget you inviting Kevin Ace X over to fix your computer, and then messaging me like, none of the computers work.
Oh, I was so
that wasn't his fault. That wasn't his fault.
Neither of them worked
like,
that.
It's just one of those things that, like, a little bit of research was important, and no one needed to do.
Nobody did.
You know?
That's why you have Kevin.
Let me just say, I've been playing some remote play on my Steam Deck, Kevin.
Yeah, yeah.
Remote play? What does that mean?
Work it
over for me, because you don't have the PS Portal, which is what remote play would be.
No, so you could. Remote play works on your phone. Remote play works on the computer.
For what though? You're remoting into your Steam account or your PlayStation?
Into my PlayStation account.
Oh, okay.
You use like a kind of like you go to like desktop mode on the Steam Deck.
Yes.
And you add an app called Chiaki for Deck.
And
I love the video because the video, it's got this guy, like maybe he's got this like Swedish accent, and I just love it because it reminds me of looking at like old 3D art tutorials.
Okay.
And he's like, and what you want to do is install Chiaki for Deck. And when you install Chiaki for Deck, he keeps on saying it that way. when you install this thing, I can then, you open up the app on your Steam Deck like normal, like you would open up any game.
Okay.
And it shows you, here's your PlayStation 5 on the network.
Yes.
And you wake it up, and it boots up.
Pings, yep.
Uh-huh. And then you play it. And this shit was flawless all weekend, and then fucking Baird got back, dude.
So it was like flawless because no one else was using the Wi-Fi.
I mean, I just thought it was going to be
just strong enough to do it.
I thought it was going to be a flawless experience regardless. And then last night, it's like the most framey shit ever. And I was like, oh, man, this sucks.
Fuck, I should have hit a bear to play fucking Helldivers.
He's addicted. He's got a problem.
It's good stuff. Too. Yeah. I hit.
Mesh Network, think about it. Or just tell me what.
What do you mean, think about it?
Kevin.
I recommended Mesh Network to you already. Remember? Love. Didn't I send you a text?
And like, we'll come over.
Oh, my God.
We'll all get spices 100%. Together.
It's so easy.
Send me another link. Send me another Mesh Network.
Okay. And I can bring a lot of toys in the shelf.
I don't want you to come over.
And he's my ride, man, dude. You know, he's my ride. I can't go there without him taking me.
That's not
I don't
true.
Know where you live.
I don't need
I don't
you to.
Know he doesn't know.
I don't know where the address is.
I just want a goddamn link, for the love of God.
See, that's the problem. I sent you one that was on sale last time.
Yeah.
Now it's going to be more expensive.
Yeah, but me and Barry will go half and half on it.
Okay. Go half and half on a mesh.
Yeah.
Sure.
And then we get spices.
Then we get spices after Jesse. Then we never have to come over.
Can you run a wire to where you want the other one to be? One should be in like the front of the house, and the other one should be in the back.
Who's got the hard lines? Who gets the record?
Barrett has it.
I have a hard line.
You get the hard line.
You have a hard line?
Yeah.
So what you would do is put one pod in where Barrett has it set up. I think it's his bedroom.
Yeah.
And then the hard line's going to that one, and then it keeps going to your.
Well, the router's in the living room.
See, that's the problem.
Oh, is it?
Sharing the router.
Yeah.
No, that's not a problem.
I said I get the router.
The mess. I mean, yeah, he's also the only one.
I made sure
that
the gentleman
care.
Installed the router. I said, sir, I did this. And he goes, well, that's not really where it goes. Instead, you're going to figure it out.
I believe in you. Yeah, the router's in the living room. Yeah,
okay.
Yeah. And I have a hard wire out from, it's like a router switch or whatever. And I have a hard line going to my room into another switch that plugs into all of my.
Yeah. You can still, so it would just go into the mesh one first and then still continue onto your system.
So I would put, I would essentially put a mesh in my room.
Well, you want to disable the whatever wireless router you have.
Uh-huh.
And then put one in like the living room, and then you put a point, which is the second unit, in your room. And it's like you got Wi-Fi
okay,
there.
Okay, that's what I want.
But you want those points to be as far away from each other as possible.
Oh, yeah, no, that wouldn't be the case.
Would they be really close?
Yeah, because essentially the router's like in the next room.
And you're having wireless issues.
I don't think it's a connection issue. I think it's like a congestion issue.
Have you can download a Wi-Fi analyzer and see what's going on with all the signals.
Yeah, because I always thought here's the thing. There's always been the thought that our Wi-Fi sucks because of our walls and our architecture.
Yeah.
That was always my thought.
Yeah, lead paint.
But then all weekend, this shit worked flawlessly.
Worked great.
And then Bear gets back and it's a mess. And I got to assume because all of his
downloading
fucking
games and stuff.
I mean, he said he was asleep, but like I just got to assume all his devices are now there. Him and Alyssa's phone and the iPad or whatever the fuck else, you know.
The
so
dog.
Like fucking dog.
You know, the dog.
Lulu.
She's been gone.
Yeah.
The dog was gone too?
Yeah. They took
the
dog.
Wow.
Yeah,
what's that like?
They wanted a little vacation.
Well, they didn't take the dog. The dog went to a dog sitter.
Oh, I thought they took the dog.
No.
What's that like? What's having the whole house to yourself nights?
You just walking around, dick out?
It was cool, but it was also like, I also, usually they give me a heads up and they'll let me know.
Okay, hey, we're leaving.
So like, I should just look at the calendar, but like, I didn't really.
But I mean like every meeting, we're also like, all right, Barrett's out for these 4 days.
There's a calendar.
It was on the calendar that he was out until Tuesday.
Calendar. I thought they had
But I'm saying in our meetings, they're like, all right, Barry is going to be out on Friday.
I guess I didn't know until it was Tuesday. I didn't know they were out until Tuesday is the thing.
Oh, shit. You went the whole weekend without knowing.
No, I thought they were coming back on Monday.
Oh, okay.
So even like that extra, I was like, shit, they're not back yet. Yeah. You know, fucking.
You're loving it.
You're like, I could have had my dick out right now.
I was loving it. I was loving it.
Dick out.
Wi-Fi was great.
Wi-Fi was
I was that. Playing the shit out of my Steam Deck just like, this is awesome. This remote play worked flawlessly. And on the OLED Steam Deck, it looked unbelievably good. And I was like, shit, I don't feel any lag here. I am playing this game over my own cloud network. I get it. I understand why y'all have been talking about remote play for so long. And then fucking Baird had to ruin it, dude.
We need a mesh network.
Mesh network.
It's interesting, though. I wonder, because, the issue with the mesh network is essentially you have two Wi-Fi bubbles, let's say, right? And
they're like mushroom clouds. They go up and then expand.
Oh.
So, let's say
he
your phone.
Me that, Craig.
Your phone.
From
whatever,
from your internet service.
Yeah.
Do you know which company you have?
AT&T?
AT&T is probably AT&T.
Or Sonic?
No, it's AT&T.
No, oh, AT&T. Okay. Yeah, I don't think they have. Anyways, but like basically, it if you're in the first bubble, your phone connects to that one, right?
Yeah.
But then if you're going into the second bubble, if the signal is not strong enough to tell your phone, like, hey, connect to this one, it might stay connected to the first one, and then you'll have a weak signal with interference coming
through. Can't have a weak signal.
Yeah. That's why you want those kind of as far away as possible.
Okay.
Yeah. But, you know, I mean, you could buy it, test it out, see if it works, return it.
Yeah, do that.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to get Andy Cortez of Mesh Network to elevate his Wi-Fi. He deserves everything and more. And we also deserve a nice little spices dinner.
We do.
You know what I mean? We should all think about that.
I had some the other day.
Preferably on Wednesdays.
I'd rather not. I don't want anybody that I know to see you interacting with this woman.
I like seeing
it. It's a special love.
It's so.
You can tell it's special. It's pure from Mike's side.
It's pure.
Very
again,
sexual,
like, I don't know if it's motherly or if it's romantic.
There's no. We
won't find out until season three.
It's very like MILF Manor. Like, is he a son or is he the kid trying to hang with the mom?
Are they going to bang? Is he about to be a stepfather or is he going to take care of the child in a brotherly manner?
Yeah, what's going on here? We haven't quite figured that out yet. But, you know, Andy deserves it all. And you, the audience out there, deserve a really fun day. That's why today we are wrapping up Final Fantasy VII Remake right here, right now, to give you the rundown. We are back. We are in Shinra H freaking Q, okay? We broke in to go save Aerith the Ancient.
The Ancient.
They were trying to get a hold of
Aerith. Oh, she's out. You got her.
She's got the ancient blood, yes.
Trying to suck out her blood.
She's tapped into the motherland, right?
Oh, yeah.
Because the ancients were the first people on the planet.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
They know how to really connect with the Mako, right,
uh-huh.
in a positive way. And so they want to use Aerith to now find the new... What's the play called?
What's the what?
What's the play called?
Plate?
Yeah, the plate. What do we call it? There's a word for it.
Placo.
No. The city, the town.
A new Midgar?
Yeah, they want Neo Midgar. They want to make Neo Midgar
where the
big Mako supply is, right? So they want to find where the promised land is to then go and make Neo Midgar because they know they've sucked this one dry. Okay, they've used it all up and they know there's a promise of something bigger and better. And so, dude, some crazy fucking shit, okay? One, there's the hot lady that looks like Lady B. But she's not Lady B. She's like the head of communications. She's got her feet up on dudes.
Oh, my God.
Holy cannoli,
let me tell
man.
You, I mean.
Holy
so
cow.
So, you're not going to play the DLC, right?
I mean, I would like to, but you can tell me all
Do we have time?
We'll see. I mean, we have all week next week, too. So, like, we have time to do it. Why?
She's in the main, like, she's.
Oh, shit, really?
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
And it's a treat.
Oh, wait, I think actually treat. Next week we're just going to play Helldivers the whole
Helldivers.
Week.
Helldivers. I mean, it might be Helldivers all the time.
But yeah, you
we'll
know what
see.
I mean?
So, she's running around. She hasn't really battled us yet, but like you know, she's bad to the bone as well. She's all about the corporation, right?
Mm-hmm.
Then we got the president of Shinra and Big H. They're doing stuff, but we've met a new jabroni. We've met two new jabronis. Big H is the head of security, we'll call him.
Yeah. Heimlich?
Heisenberg. Something like that,
yeah.
You know what I mean? And so here's the deal. We've met two new jabronis. One jabroni, who's good. He doesn't really like how the team is going right here. It's the head of the corporation. He would prefer us to go a different route, maybe save the people, save the planet, but they don't really
White
care
hair.
About him. Yeah, and I don't know why they're okay with this guy, like being on the board. If you're going to go against everything evil that we want to do, kick the good out. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, if I run an evil corporation and you're trying to bring good and light into this, you're out. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
I'm Dr. Evil in you. I'm dropping you in a pit full of laser sharks.
He's handsome, right?
Yeah, he's handsome. He's a good looker. He looks like you. Very handsome.
Thank you. Don't wink at me. Don't
I got it.
Got it. What do you mean I got it?
Yeah, what did you get?
We all three people. I'll take it back. I'm gonna get to the third guy in just a minute. Second person,
Mike. It's just you be like, got him on the Uno thing. It's so fucking
God
good.
Damn.
Got him.
My favorite was Nick Lito. He's falling asleep. So tired, Mike. And then Andy was just like, Mike has done nothing. Just done out. Mike
no, that was Chad. Chad was like, Mike hasn't been on any content today. Why is he asleep?
We're going to 5 o'clock and fall asleep in the chair. So now second dude that we met is the evil scientist. This dude,
Hojo.
Andy? Yo.
Hojo Dojo House.
Dude is,
yeah.
Yo, he's doing some weird stuff.
He's
right?
the first guy where you're like, oh, they are capable of making an ugly dude in this game.
Uh-huh. Yeah, yeah. And
because they want him to look ugly and evil.
Oh, you want to feel the evilness in this guy.
And he's I'll a Hofa Joe.
This guy is as evil as can be. He's doing some messed up stuff, and now he's got a hold of Aerith, and he wants to take it to the next level.
Yeah.
He wants to take her and, like, essentially breed her with either himself or somebody perfect, which is Sethi. You know what I mean? It's probably Sethi.
Yeah.
He probably wants to breed her with Sethi, or I think once he lays eyes on me and he knows that I've been bathed in the Mako, a.k.a. Cloud,
you're beautiful.
He kind of wants me too. He's like, how can I do some really fucked up shit? And I'm telling you, we put a stop to that, okay? We're going to let that happen. So fast forward, we didn't let that happen, ladies and gentlemen. Third guy I wanted to introduce you to was the mayor. We didn't really talk about him, but he was the secret undercover guy for Avalanche within Shinra. So there was always a question mark of, like, how is Avalanche getting all this information right here from inside of Shinra out to the Avalanche team? And it was the mayor the whole time. They shoved the mayor in the library.
I got to Google this dude. I don't know how.
Yeah, you got to Google the mayor.
Dude with the beard?
Yeah, they booted his ass into a bookshelf inside the library. And he was like, yo, I'm helping out Avalanche because I hate this. You know what I mean? And it's like, yo, we got you, mayor. So the mayor gave us all the inside information, just so you know.
Oh, that's right. The guy, Rufus is his name.
Yeah. And
a weird fucking name.
We saved the mayor. You know, the mayor's happy for us. We've saved Aerith. We've also unlocked Red 13.
Ah.
Which is a crazy leopard man. He talks.
Yeah.
And we don't quite know what his vibe is. Like, I want to...
Jessica Howard had a question on Twitter about this.
Okay.
More canine or more feline?
Wait, any relation?
More canine, more feline.
To Mike Howard.
Yeah, no. That's my sister.
yeah.
But shout out to Jess. She's incredible.
Cool
She's incredible.
Yeah.
She's the best.
Because I voted canine. Really? I voted more like a dog.
What?
Yeah.
No, it's more cat.
That's a tiger.
More feline. That's a leopard.
Canine
saber-tooth.
Won the vote.
Yeah. Really?
Yeah.
But over feline.
Over feline.
You think so? What, wolf?
Isn't that Lupin? Isn't that Lupin?
Let me look.
That's an interesting one. That's an interesting vibe. I believe I go with cat, like Kevin. More saber-tooth, tiger, leopard, panther type vibes. You know what I mean? But we freed him. And we don't quite know about him yet. Like, he's definitely now down to ride with us because we saved him. But also at the same time, we know nothing about him. And so in my mind, I've leaped to conclusions because I love leaping to conclusions. This is the guy
leaping like a leopard.
This is the guy that wanted to save Tifa back at the wall market that we met briefly.
Oh,
Johnny or something. Johnny Bravo, who had the weird beard.
The three goatee.
Because, like, he had a goatee. And so my mind goes to, he got captured. And
turned into a cat.
They turned his ass.
That's a theory.
Turned your ass into a goddamn cat.
That is definitely a theory. That's not, I mean, based on what Final Fantasy has done, that's not far off. You're not crazy for thinking that.
And so now here we are. The whole crew has assembled. We are breaking out of Shinra HQ, as you can see. But inside of it, there's a big reactor. There's like a mind flare type situation. It's got a lot of oogly googly shit into it's the mother. Fuck it, I take it all back. Inside of this test chamber is something that Sethi and possibly Cloud are calling mother.
Genova.
Holy shit, and what the fuck is inside of that? Something fucked up. Something they've been testing on, that's for sure. Like, it's some crazy stuff.
A lot of experiments, a lot of science.
Now our goal is to get up to the big reactor because we got to figure out what's inside of this. Sethi, I believe, is real now, and he's here. I just want everyone to
know. Okay.
Like, Sethi is
not a figment
real.
Of our imagination.
No, you know, the Mako High has worn off.
Yeah.
We are now back to reality. Sethi is definitely in the house.
The call's coming from inside the house.
You wake up from the super high.
Yeah.
And you're like, oh, shit.
Yeah.
I think somebody was in the house.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Sethi was there.
Sethi was there. Yeah.
Do we ever find out more about this Red 13 and why it's just a lion that's, like, cool and talks? Has, like, cool hair accessories?
He was being experimented on. I don't really know the full lore, but let me just spoil it. It's not Johnny.
Oh, shit. Really? Damn.
It's not a person. It wasn't a person that turned into a cat.
Okay. I really thought it was Johnny. That's crazy. That's crazy.
I mean, they sound real different, though.
Oh, yeah, but you know I got a bad ear.
But one of them is Yuri Lowenthal, who voices Spider-Man.
I got a bad ear.
And the other one's definitely not that dude. Let's play the fucking game.
So we're back to the game. We were in two separate groups working together to try to solve this puzzle. And a weird puzzle right now to get up to mommy, okay? So that's, we're caught up. You're caught up. Welcome in, chat.
Welcome. Thank you. Thank you for that recap.
Give me a gold star if you thought that recap was pretty
good. The Fafi Poupe Fo 4.
Name still to be determined. Still working the name. Still working the name.
Does anyone want a bagel?
No, but I also requested that Joey get donuts, and she ignored it. So
she didn't get donuts?
I was like, I like how Andy slid in Krispy Kreme to like let her know.
Nothing.
Krispy Kreme, so now on.
Didn't she say she was going to get donuts?
No.
We should. I mean, Krispy Kreme's, we should do Krispy Kreme's once a week. I know that like we're kind of mixed on that, but like every Friday should be Krispy Kreme.
It should be once a month, man.
Okay, well, that's kind of like, that's a little too light.
But I think on KF Podcast, maybe it was something else. Tim was like, it's too much.
Yeah, I think it's once a month. I think it's a monthly thing.
Really, you don't think 12 donuts?
No, because here's the thing.
I heard we didn't deserve it, so.
It's a monthly thing that happens more than once a month because we'll have a guest walk in and they'll get donuts on the way, you know?
Love that. Kevin, no, but I would like my iced chai out of the fridge if you could grab that for me. And one napkin to blow my nose, please.
Sir.
Thank you, homie. So, Andy, I'm going to need your help here.
Yeah, what's up,
bro? Because this is just an awkward part. It's a lot of back and forth, and I'm not quite sure what the fuck is going on. I'm a little lost in this, so just something to keep in mind. Oh, shit, never mind. I got to fight somebody. Hold up.
Fight these Power Ranger guys.
Yeah. The lizard men. Yeah, what are these things? I mean, he was testing on people. You know, he was testing on things, and this is what it is.
Yeah, well, a lot of these entities were grown by Hojo,
yeah.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
Working on that ancient blood.
Yeah.
Remember that she's not a pure blood.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Mother is the
pure
blood.
She's a muggle.
She's kind of a muggle, I think.
Oh,
but it's just enough. It's enough for him to work.
But the dad, part Jedi. They're super powerful.
That's crazy, bro.
The dad is Radagon.
What is this place for? There's a sadness.
Yeah, there's a sadness because I'd be testing on.
I can't walk into a place and sense a sadness. That feels like some ancient type power
that's
shit.
The shit where we walk the other way.
Yeah.
Because, like, that's bad. That's a bad omen. You walk into a room like this, it's going on you, and then you got bad juju on you for the rest of your
Get
life.
Back in my car.
Yeah, bad vibes. Oh, shit. The dog thing.
So, yeah, those little scary black dogs.
You don't like that the light goes on and off, you know what I mean? I'll tell you what.
They're being experimented on. They're scared. They're scared just
They
like
don't
us.
Want to be there, that's right. But they're also trained to kill, you know what I mean? Or they're like so upset that they have to kill now.
Creed says, Andy's overseeing the gameplay, so Mike is opening chests again.
Creed.
Fucking busted. Because I heard that you haven't been opening shit.
Oh, they were going crazy on me the last
round. It's easy, bro. You don't need
to,
man.
I was trying to explain to them. They were like, Mike, you're ruining my mind right now. As I ran past every single chest in the video game.
It was weirdly frustrating. And I know it shouldn't have been, but it was. Oh, this is for you.
Thank you, homie. Appreciate you. What kind of bagel did you get?
Asiago pesto.
Did you get a bagel? Did you treat yourself?
No.
I don't think anyone else got a bagel. Well.
Accio Pepe.
It looks like maybe, like no one had gotten any
it's
of the cream
long.
Cheese.
It's real loud, right?
Yeah, it's a little loud.
Okay. Yeah,
that's
cool.
Probably because of the trailer.
Trailer was good.
Yeah,
that
good
was great.
Trailer.
That was surprising.
Bring it up again.
You know, let's talk about that for 20
minutes.
Put
a picture in picture. Remove us up there, but the Borderlands trailer. You're forced to break boxes now.
Yeah, exactly. Get out of that way. I said, get out of here. So many characters. Remember when we were battling, what's his name, Don Corleone?
Yeah.
Don Corleone.
Holy shit, it's a great bagel.
Twice, bro. And Donnie was just giving up all the beans. He was spilling all the beans, bro.
Oh, bird, man.
Oh, no, it's a chicken thing, is right.
Yeah, it's a bird
chicken
cat.
Chicken lizard man.
You think this is like Red 12?
Maybe.
Zini.
This kind of feels like Ninja Turtles, Kevin. All the animals being worked on.
Yeah, I can see that.
You know,
yeah.
We got Red 13, half dog, half cat.
Damn. No, I'm pretty sure he's just lion.
Full dog.
Full dog.
All dog.
Doggy style.
Do you think any of the other animals get smart and like tell you about their feelings?
I think they may have the potential to. I don't know if they fully get there though.
Fair. Is the red 15 in the like the future plays a decent part, or is this like the cat just comes by once and disappears forever?
I mean, he's in the game right
he's
now.
He's in the game.
Good stuff.
Yeah, he's,
yeah,
in the
he's
game.
Been helping me. You were here last time with me, right, Kev? Yeah, yeah, yeah. Was you alive?
He's in Rebirth. We saw in the trailer.
Who was with me? Oh, no, you left halfway through, remember? Yeah, it was just me. Because that was Madam Web Day.
Big day. They play that when the movie starts.
Do they really?
Yeah. No, I'm kidding.
Madam Web.
It's so bad, man.
You think you're going to fall no matter what you do?
Oh, yeah, of course. You'd be stupid to think otherwise.
Too many bodies. See, you always go one at a time. That's my rule. You and I, we're out in the middle of the Amazon. We see a bridge. One at a time.
We're studying spiders.
You go first.
Did we wake him up? You play. You cross.
You're going to do great. Walk over there. See what happens.
They got a cool look to them. They got cool, like, hair-beard combo.
Yeah, these guys.
You could pull this off. You could pull off this hair with this beard.
Okay, the red. Thank you.
You would have to shave the mustache, but it would just be all around. It would be like a lion's mane.
Okay. Yeah, I'm sorry.
Kevin's telling me no, because he knows that Mike will try anything that anybody says he'll look good in.
We're not dedicated to one look.
We know.
Just like, you know, you might dye your hair blonde one day. We'd like that.
Maybe.
I'd like that a lot.
Maybe.
I think we got it.
Blonde or silver?
We go to a... Oh, you go silver.
Well, I think it'd be like a... there'd be less yellow in the blonde.
So okay. Platinum.
Yeah.
All right.
Okay.
Which
we go to a very trusted hair specialist.
I get you a hair specialist.
You know one?
Oh, yeah. Oh, remember, Paul used to be platinum for a long time.
I would... Here's the thing, though. I would...
You don't be scared.
I would need to have like an interview with this person and be like, can you guarantee that I won't lose my hair?
Yeah, that's the big...
No one can make that guarantee, just so you know.
We need the guarantee.
Also, because of how dark your hair is, and it's very dark, because Paula has brown hair.
Yeah.
You've
it would take multiple layers
of nearly
black primer. You'd be priming the wall for a long time.
You're going to lose a lot of hair for sure. Like, a lot of hair is going to fall out.
So that's scary.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
But then on the flip side, I also think about how when people have blonde hair, it's harder to see their scalp.
Okay.
Because a person, if a person has dark hair,
you can see.
You see the scalp easier when they're balding.
I don't think that's true.
Yeah, it is. Yeah. Absolutely.
My mom was blonde hair my entire life, and Tim's mom, you could see their scalps easily.
It's harder.
I used to get sunburned all the time.
I'm talking about like on camera though. Like it'd be harder for the audience to see my balding.
Sure. Yeah.
You're not balding, Andy.
I am balding.
It's in your head.
I'm fully 100% convinced that I only have hair because of fucking Propecia.
Look, I'm happy you found something that makes you feel like it's.
Bro, I'm telling you, Kevin.
It's in your head.
That's the hair loss. Well, that's the name brand pill.
Like the pill.
But But what's the generic version of it? No, but the generic name of the pill, you know?
For men.
It's like you could buy Aleve, but the pill is ibuprofen, thing.
Yes.
Or you could get a Claritin, but it's called Zetirizine or whatever the fuck.
I love Claritin, yeah.
Finasteride, thank you, chat.
That means nothing, I think, either of us.
Finasteride is just the generic name for the pill, because Propecia is finasteride. Just name branded.
Yeah.
Mike, you know? Do you ever have moments where you're like maybe getting out of the shower, drying your hair off, and then just look and you're like, huh, it's thinner than it used to be.
No,
Michael never loses.
Yeah,
hair,
but I'm not looking that hard at it. Yeah. I would say I haven't looked like that. You know what I mean?
Dude, my sink and floor are like.
Well, hair falls out. That's normal.
It's always really short hair, which means that like my hair is going through another one of those shedding phases where it loses some hair and then it grows back and then it loses more and then it grows back later.
I read somewhere that it's your turn. I got this. Estimate you lose something like 80 to 200 hairs a day. So,
yeah. Yeah, sure, but it's in my genes. And
the hair?
And that's why when my mom was cutting my hair when I was 23 years old. She then gifted me Rogaine.
Right off the rip, she said, get ready.
She was like, you're losing your hair.
Just so you know, my mom, every time she sees me, she's like, wow. The hair's receding a lot, huh?
Pelon.
And it's like, no, it's the same.
My hair's receding and I'm also thinning on top. You look at younger photos of me, dude. I'm a six head now. He always used to be a five head. I'm a six head, seven head now. Four head is long gone.
I like seeing a little bit of little salt in my hair. See a couple of little.
I have a bunch.
A couple pieces, nothing crazy.
As I've been growing out the sides and the back, like I see so many more white hairs.
It's crazy when I look at the top. It's like it's so much up there now. Wild.
I do feel lucky to see white hairs like in the front, where I'm like. Oh, there's still some life there.
We used the control panel here a little while ago, so you should be able to get to the.
It's like
side.
like a rose growing, like a flower growing in an apocalypse. Yeah, you know, it's like
the sunflower after radiation.
It's a flower growing in the Morocco.
Ah, shit, bro, can love bloom on the battle?
Stay there. We'll call if anything comes up.
Look at this.
It's cool that sunflowers leach radiation.
I didn't
like
know
they,
that.
You throw sunflowers when there's radiation, it helps.
They become mutants.
No, I mean, it pulls it in. It pulls it in. It helps clean it up. Cleans it up. Yep.
Oh, wow.
They don't understand it. They don't, Jace the Drone. Like, I've been going bald, bro.
It doesn't look it.
It doesn't look
it. I mean, I do a great job of hiding it. Melissa with a Y the other day was like, you should part your hair in the middle in real life. And I was like, yeah, right, dude. It would be obvious how much thinning I've got.
Show us.
No, it's embarrassing.
Because here's the thing. Nick doesn't try to hide it, I would think. And I can't tell Nick's hair is any thinner than it was when he first started working here.
I essentially have a comb over.
When he started this company.
I'm really disappointed Nick's not here today. I love seeing him.
At all?
I don't know. I just haven't seen him yet.
Okay, all right. That's
all. It's like when I don't see you or Andy, I'm like, I'm very disappointed.
What is this?
Well, if he's got nothing on the calendar,
Well, I know. I just like spending time with him.
Yeah.
You know, because I missed him yesterday or Monday. We were supposed to play Call of Duty, but then I ate dinner for like an hour, so it's like my bad, you know.
Oh, that's right.
He flaked on him.
He said 8 o'clock. He got on at 8 o'clock, but then I proceeded to eat. You know what I mean? Because I was hungry after the stream, and then it's just like, oh shit, I missed it.
That's right. We were playing Helldivers, and Nick was like, "All right, I'm gonna peace out, y'all." And we're like, "All right, later, Nick." And then like 40 minutes later, Mike pops in. And he's like, "All right, I'm here."
Nick, you here? Nick, I'm here. Yeah, I put too much lemon pepper. So you know what? I'm having a seasoning problem with my cooking.
Oh, okay, let me hear it.
You know what I mean? I'm having a seasoning problem. So first it started off with, you know, I had some good seasoning. Then I had Montreal steak seasoning. I'm past that now.
What do you put any of that on?
Steak piece seasoning anymore. My steak, sometimes chicken, you know what I mean? Whatever kind of protein I'm cooking that day.
Yeah, how can I zest it up?
Yeah, a little zest. And I had this Chipotle that was very good. I liked the kick on it.
Okay.
But then I ran out of that because I was using it too much. So I went to Montreal steak. I was like, you know what? Time has passed. I don't vibe with this anymore. My taste buds don't smack with this anymore. Mm. And so I went to this store and I was like, I need some help. You know what I mean? I need to cook something up here. What am I gonna do? And so I went over to, I got lemon pepper, and I love a good little lemon pepper zest on things.
Nice.
But you can overdo it. You know what I mean?
Yeah, for sure.
If you just start fucking shaking it like I do, you know what I mean?
But I always feel like I'm okay with that.
Just a little too much?
Like, I'd rather go more than less.
Yeah. I agree with that. Yeah. There's a line, but like sometimes, you know, sometimes a little too much, you know.
Vince Patel says, Mike, go back to the central thing. Hit switch number two.
Oh, nice. Okay. You think so? Okay, cool.
I think I can say with some confidence, Vince, I've never gone too far.
On the seasoning.
You know what I mean? I like over-seasoning.
You ever have spicy lemon pepper wings from Pluckers?
No, I've never been to Pluckers.
Fuck.
Yeah, I know.
Oh, man.
It really sucks.
Fuck.
It's unfair.
That's insane.
The amount of times I didn't go to fucking
RTX?
Yeah. Sucks. Commencing test of augmented
research. You would have gone had I not worked there.
No, it was too late at that point.
Can you believe that we're getting the Raising Cane's? They got that Texas toast bread that's just so good.
But there's one like 40 minutes away.
That's too far.
All right. I don't disagree. I don't disagree.
I mean, it kind of is, yeah.
That's just a little.
But it could be an adventure.
But like if we're passing, you know, I went to Stanford. Went to Stanford for the first time.
Did you go to the mall?
No, I went to the campus itself.
Oh, what are you doing at Stanford?
Imagine me if I went to Stanford. You
know what I mean? I mean, you'd be a very different person. In every single way.
Not me.
I mean, you could certainly try to put somebody in Stanford and see what happens to them. I would just imagine your brain would leak.
So I went to Stanford and walked around the campus. Beautiful goddamn campus.
Yeah?
You never knew that.
Just for fun? Was this a fun thing?
Yeah, I was looking for things to do, you know what I mean?
It's gorgeous.
And like,
this when you were out doing a thing?
Yeah. Well, this was this was just me on a Sunday.
Oh,
this
okay.
is my weekend adventure. I'm getting back into weekend adventuring. I, you know, I've taken a couple weeks off here, and I'm just staring at the wall for too long. I gotta get outside again.
Mm-hmm.
And so I called a Big Mike because he was sick. We were gonna go up to Shasta Lake together.
Oh,
take him on a mega trip. Mm.
Mount Shasta? That's a 9-hour drive. Well worth it.
Yeah, there's very good time. And so he was sick, unfortunately. And so I was
you were gonna do that on a Sunday?
Well, because I was Monday off, remember? I was supposed to have Monday off.
Oh, fuck. That would have been really good. That would have been really good.
And so, unfortunately for me, your boy, he was sick. And I was like, where do I go? And if we, Kevin, will you buy me a map?
One step at a time.
I would like a map to put my pins on of all the places I go. My iPhone maps have pins on all the places that I've gone, but I'd like something that I can show.
Are you playing the game?
You know what I mean? Well, he's talking.
Yeah.
It's Hojo.
They're trying to shoot a Hojo up there.
You know, your Google map
should
have markers on where you are, or if you use Google Photos, it'll have markers where you went.
Yeah, I rock Google. Oh, I rock Apple.
Okay. So you want me to order you a physical map?
Yeah, I want a physical map.
And this is a work-related purchase?
Yeah.
Okay, you want it to be on a pin board? And we can have
Like to be able to pin. I would like to be able to
pin. And so you want it as decoration for the back? Perfect.
Cool. All of my adventures.
Kevin, just know you don't have to do any of this, because he'll forget about this in a week.
I know. But it gives me something to do.
You know what I mean? And Kevin loves
just
that.
Just entertain yourself for a bit.
I would like a California map,
just
I think.
Just give that kid an iPad and tell him to shut the fuck up.
Andy, I've been dabbling in making my own ice cream.
What?
Me and Kevin together, bro. Dabbling and making ice cream.
Really thought it was going to be a related aside.
Well, I mean, I opened up Amazon, and the first thing that is up there is an ice cream machine.
Oh. Okay.
That's great. Good for you, Kevin. That's wonderful.
Yeah, I made,
how's that going? How's that experiment?
I made lavender honey, 2 days ago.
I don't
incredible.
Know, you like lavender honey ice cream?
No, that sounds awful.
Incredible.
Because I hear lavender and I taste when sometimes you use an air freshener, you're like, yeah.
No, it doesn't taste like
that's
that.
That's gotta be it.
It tastes like honey, but like when you breathe out, it's honey or lavender like scent.
No, wait, didn't. Who was I with that I had a lavender drink with? Was that you?
Might have been. No, it might have been. I just remember you, me, and Ryan Colt Levy went out tonight.
What happened to your mic? Hold on. No, you're fine. Stop
my mic. Hello?
Stop it. Just stop working. Oh, there you go. You seem like you're coming in so quiet.
I know that you like sherbet.
Where were we that a lavender... Who was I with? A lavender drink was purchased, was really expensive, and nobody liked... Oh! Simon Cardi.
When we went out,
no, that was like hibiscus.
In the rain,
it was hibiscus.
Lavender basil is another mixed flavor that they do.
That place, yeah.
Anywho, the other ice cream I made, Nutella. Incredible.
Nutella.
Incredible.
Delicious. Ojo's being a hoe.
Ojo's still alive? Damn, dude, this guy. You know,
relentless.
Always, the super evil ones always kind of, you know, just survive.
They find the ways to survive.
Yeah, they find the way is right. And you don't want them to. It's like, they shouldn't be. This is where he tests his subjects to make sure they got the grit.
Yeah.
You didn't think California is like, that's just too, like, it's just one space? Kind of. You know? You don't want to do... United States, the world.
Yeah. Where's he gonna put it?
I like this look, Kevin.
Yeah, I thought you'd like this. That's why I picked this
one. He likes the look of that one.
150 pins. What does that mean?
I don't want that. I'm good. I'm okay with that.
Mark, talk for me.
This is Mike talking right here. Red 13 is about to go kill. He's about to claw Hojo.
Okay.
All right. Oh.
Whoa.
Oh, so close.
What's happening? Is Red 13 a robot?
No, I think he's got some sort of stasis field on him.
The midichlorians.
Yeah. That's wild, bro.
You tell me that looks like the paw of a dog to you? That's a feline paw.
He barked right there.
Oh, look at it. It's whack-a-mole. The sledge one.
This is where they test all the... This is like a ESPN Sports Science right here.
So this is where you would... Careful. a test subject in, and it would then beat up on the said robot.
Yeah.
That's smart. Didn't think of it like that.
This is where they track your 40 time and everything. Yes. They got you running on a treadmill with a mask on.
Science, do you remember that back
fuck
in the day?
Yeah, dude.
No, dude. God,
if Terrell Owens jumped with this velocity, that would mean he had the equal speed of a speeding bus from the movie Speed.
What happened to that? When did that?
I don't know what happened to that. John Brinkus.
Yeah, why do we not have that anymore?
Well, ESPN laid off a lot of people. I think he was first on the bucket.
You think he was first to go?
They had to be like, all right, this has got to be the first one to leave.
Oh, shit.
Which is wild, because that feels like really good social content.
Great social content nowadays.
Yeah.
ESPN's TikTok, they're a little loosey-goosey on the clips. Like, they have a lot of, like, really good clips of, like, of course, sports events. And then they have, like, really heartwarming family stuff. Then out of nowhere, they decided to post a post-game basketball brawl on the court during the handshakes. It's like, is this really what we're posting to ESPN? What's up with that?
Yeah, it's one of those things that, like, and a lot of the athletes hate it because they're like, you know, you are partnered with these leagues and you're... A lot of these people are getting fined, yet you're promoting the bad behavior.
Really weird. Really weird.
You're making money off of this bad stuff while we're having to pay for the bad stuff, you know?
Mike, I have terrible news. It's $150.
What was that thing? Hey, we got to find one for Scojo.
Yeah, that's more of the price that I was thinking. This one that is just a $14.99 piece of, I don't know why the picture has tape on it. You see this?
Let's give me a little example of how to do it.
Oh,
yeah.
Give an example.
How to, that's the instruction.
It's weird because every photo has the same tape up top. That one's $30, so it's not looking great for us.
Okay, that's crazy. We can't get like just a basic road brochure?
Like a Rand McNally?
I think I can just print out California.
Let's get Roger on it. Somebody call him. Let's get our best minds on
Roger.
This one. What the fuck is Roger doing? Tell him to go get some In-N-Out, goddamn. He's got a car now. Tell him to get Krispy Kreme.
He's got a car now, like he just got one. He's had one for months and months.
So mad at him. So mad at him. You know, every now and then I'll be reminded I just get so mad at Roger.
Just fucking acting like a baby with him.
Betrayed me.
Good morning, Roger.
You nailed that.
He looked at me and goes, I hate that, Mike. You can never do that again. Like, you know I'm just playing with you. No, you gotta stop that shit.
Speaking of things I hate.
I just love him so much.
This Manu poster. I don't know who Manu is.
Oh, I love the Manu.
Manu Ginobili.
You can say it like I know who it is.
Google
right?
him. Google top 10. Get top 10 facts about Manu Ginobili and hit him with it. Let's get the top 10 facts about Manu Ginobili.
Hall of Famer, basketball player.
Doesn't mean anything to me.
NBA champion. Wow. And won the gold medal. You know how America always wins the basketball Olympics?
Did he beat us?
Argentina. He got the gold medal for Argentina. And they beat America, which caused the whole, like, the redeem team. Where the next Olympics, all the NBA players are like, fuck that, we cannot lose again to any other country. We have to go dominate. But he's also just my favorite basketball player ever.
I don't like it.
He's the best, dude. He was a very reckless player, Kevin. Oh. And at one point, his coach Popovich for the Spurs got mad at him. And he was like, Popovich, they call him Pop.
Yeah,
and he has this very heavy Argentine. And he goes, Pop, this is what I do. And he was like, I gotta let him do what he does. Like, fuck it. Just gotta let him. Like, if he wants to do some wild shit that might cost the team bad shit, but, you know, he's gonna pop off every once in a while, too.
He also slapped the shit out of a bat.
That's right.
He did.
In San Antonio, yeah. In San Antonio, a bat was loose, and everybody was scared of it. And the bat flew next to him, and he just went, bah, and he swatted it, and it fell on the ground, and he picked it up, and he had to get a rabies shot.
Oh, you got, I mean, that's very serious. You gotta get like 28 shots, not even just one.
That's crazy. I always see whenever like you walk.
No, I think
the
they brought it down to 16.
Hmm?
No, oh, sorry.
Rabies shots.
Yeah.
Oh.
You know when you're walking through the park and like that bird flies like close to you, you know what I mean? I always stick my hand out just in case.
Just in case.
Just in case I'm gonna grab that.
Like it's gonna land on your...
Well, no, I'm gonna grab that thing, just get a hold of it, you know what I mean?
What are you gonna do with it after?
I don't know, I'm gonna look at you and say, caught that thing, you and say that was fucking nuts, Mike.
Oh, it's only four
I
now.
Caught a fucking bird.
Yeah, exactly. You see the clip I sent you of the ESPN guy over at Texas Tech calling the ball game? He goes, all right, John Johnson's up to bat. Here comes the first pitch. Oh, this ball's coming right at us, and then just fucking grabs
it. Oh, shit, no, I didn't see it.
Yeah, that shit was lit, bro. That's like my dream. You're out on a date at the ballpark. You know what I mean? Foul ball come fucking ripping at you. Bam!
Yeah.
Fucking saved you, you know what
with
I mean?
The, with nachos in the other hand, saved.
And people start cheering fucking shit. But you can't miss.
Yeah.
Don't fucking miss.
Yeah.
Oh, he definitely didn't have to do
one
that.
One step at a time it is.
I don't see any elevators around here. I'll let you turn in if you know.
Bat was loose, man.
The bat was fucking loose.
That's how they handle it in Argentina.
Now the mascot gets a net and runs around.
Yeah, the mascot, who's a coyote, wears a Batman suit.
Yep. Gets out there.
Project L update tomorrow. No, I didn't hear that, Nitro.
Is that the fighting game?
Yeah.
Oh.
What do you know? That's the door to the fourth wall.
I don't know why, but that was one of the best bagels I've ever had. Way back to the
central terminal. It's good bagels. And it's weird because it's from House of Bagels, so it's not like it's anything special.
You don't like House of Bagels?
No, I mean like they're good bagels, but like,
well,
like a mom and pop shop or like a
Wait, House of Bagels is a chain?
Yeah, it's a chain. It's a chain.
Yeah, I think it might be owned by like Noah's Bagels.
Yeah, I don't think it's anything like
it. It wasn't a chain before.
I'd assume that if someone's going to have good bagels, it's where
the house
a house that has them.
House of Bagels. You know who I like? Down in Pacifica. You got John's Bagels, Johnny's Bagels.
Nah, I feel like you're making stuff up.
It's not that good, but like, you know, the guy's kind of weird, so it's fun.
It's not that good, but the guy's kind of weird.
He's just kind of loose, you know what I mean? He's kind of loose.
So that enhances the taste, or like, what?
Not really, because it's not that good.
Why don't we have donuts here? What the fuck are we doing?
Why don't we have Krispy Kreme? Tell Raj.
No, we're grateful that we got anything, all right?
We are grateful.
We could have just had nothing.
Thank you to Joey for getting that. It is bomb for sure.
I don't see a Joe's bagel. What did you say? John's?
John's bagels? John's
not
bagels?
David's.
David's bagels.
Not even close. It could have been Joe's, it could have been Jacob's, but it's fucking David.
David. We all know David. Everyone knows David.
You don't.
Everybody knows goddamn David.
This place looks very trendy, but...
Oh, no, that's not it.
No?
That's not it. No.
Hey, it's crazy because it's saying that Dave's Bagels.
Yeah, that's not what it looks like. Yeah, get in there. You play for a second. Let me look it up. No, it's like a mom and pop shop. Downtown, Main Street Pacifica.
Downtown.
That's Main Street, bro.
I mean, first of all, this is not...
That is definitely downtown.
Just so you know, this right here is down... No, wait. Lindemar, where is it?
No, you're not calling Taco Bell.
That's Lindemar, right here.
That's not Main
Just
Street.
Just so you
Pacifica.
Know, Mike, I went to high school in this place.
I'm
city.
Just letting you know.
I'll tell you right
He's
now.
Telling
you
know,
a guy that's been there for
the
3 days.
Right off the pier, there's a Main Street. That is downtown Main
that
Street.
That is
Pacifica.
Called.
That is small surfer
Manor?
Town. Everyone and their mamas going there in the summertime. That's it. That's it right there. Linda Del Mar. With the Taco Bell and shit. Absolutely not.
I'm telling you what it is.
You'll get through these. I know we're on easy.
Yeah.
But you'll get through the battles faster. And it's way too late to be telling you any of this. Mm-hmm. But.
This is Mike's town now. I know it's not like the back of my hands.
Mike owns this now, okay?
Where's the,
did we already sit? We already sat, right?
Yeah, we already sat. All
right,
I'm driving. I'm doing no maps from now on when I'm driving around town. I'm just guessing.
God, what? I'm sure that's working out great for you. He's not doing any maps.
You got to challenge yourself.
And you can't even see the street signs.
Well, when they're four blocks away, you can. But like when they're closed, I can see
Andy,
them.
He's not reading the street names. He's just feeling it out.
You gotta feel it.
You gotta feel it.
God, you will go lost one day.
I bet you I can go to your house right now. No map.
Probably, yeah, it's not hard.
It's so easy. It, you know? Andy, that's why he has to drive me. I'm the final test.
Oh.
The final test. It's a test. You just gotta feel it.
How the fuck? Where do we go? Where do I go?
Remember when Mike said he's been in SF for 2 weeks? He's seen it all. I've seen it. Trust me, Chad, I've seen it all.
It's crazy because there's
only
areas.
A 7x7 block. There's not much going on.
There's so many areas you've never been to.
Take me there. I'll tell you, I've been there.
I know you'll tell me. It won't make it true.
Okay, I get the cat man over there.
Here, do the... Wait, what do I gotta do?
I don't know. I gotta press a button. Up and triangle or something like that.
Up there where I was?
Yeah, you stand there. The cat man runs across. He's gonna hit that switch.
Oh, that's right.
Yeah, that's how it goes.
That's right. Yeah. That's right.
Mike, you ever go to Gorilla Barbecue?
I have.
Well, what do you think?
Fine. Please.
I don't want to hear
not
that.
Not bad. Not as good as Sweet Babies.
Oh.
Baby Blues.
Sweet Baby Race.
Baby Blues fucks. But Gorilla is fine. There's not many barbecue places around here, so that's why it's like, you know, in here it's better than fine. It's good. But like, it's fine.
The other day I was looking for a barbecue place. I ended up going to a barbecue place, but it was like Asian.
Hey, oh.
Very interesting.
Okay. Okay.
All the meat just had one flavor to it. There was no variation. You could get that flavor in like, hey, do you want chicken liver? Did you want beef?
You want to kill these guys faster, Mike? Use the cess. I'm telling you.
Too bad. Okay.
Instead of just wailing on them, now you know this thing will die super fast with ice.
But you want me to not learn and then do that? Okay.
Well, like, it's just like, you know, instead of slashing at him for a long time, even though I know we're on easy.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I think like the issue that happens in easy is like you don't have to do that because like you slash and he's already like 3/4 through his health and you're like, oh shit, do I really need to call him a spell now? You know what I mean? But I get it. I feel that.
For the harder enemies, it'll get that health bar way quicker down. They get staggered way quicker. He's fucking wailing their bitch asses.
Odd that you don't play as Red here. Like, have you noticed that we've had a couple instances where like Red could be called in. Red's not playing. Oh, we gotta go help.
Man, I forgot how stretched out this final segment is.
This right here.
Yeah, this whole area.
Yeah, a lot of conversation about this.
Is it bad?
Tifa. I don't know. I mean, a lot of people said, like, we're really. There's moments where they really stretched it out. Like, there was moments in, like, the Wall Market part two where it was like, we didn't have to come back here. That's where we met Leslie again. Tell us his beautiful love story, which I appreciate, you know what I mean? Don't get me wrong. It was a beautiful goddamn love story. But, like, I didn't have to hear that.
Remember when Andy said barbecue sauce sucks? I mean, it's overrated.
He doesn't. He's just doing it for a joke.
I don't think it sucks.
He doesn't even mean it.
Does she have excess?
He immediately took it back.
No, I don't think so. I think only Cloud has it. But Electric's probably gonna take these dudes down way faster.
Go on. I don't think she has it.
She doesn't have Thunder, or?
No, she got Blizzaro and Fire.
What about Aerith?
I'll show you what I can do.
I mean, she's your Steez the Source. Oh, she doesn't.
We'll make it quick.
And we got Thundara over here.
What a wild thing to say.
I love this house.
Yeah.
It's just overrated.
No, it's not. It's really not.
It's just like I'd pick a million other sauces over it.
No, you wouldn't.
Medium and hot.
What does that even mean?
Frank Dreadhot. Yes. Oh, you're a Frank's
Yeah, buffalo guy? Sauce. Yeah, oh, yeah.
Yeah, the Frank's Red buffalo sauce. Great stuff. I like to make some chicken. Just give myself a little salad, a little buffalo chicken salad. Toss that chicken.
There used to be a restaurant in Pacifica, like deep in the valley. All right? Now, Mike, that term probably doesn't mean anything.
Deep in the valley? So you mean over by Taco Bell?
No. See, you don't know what you're saying.
Ooh, I like spicy Korean stuff. Korean barbecue.
Korean barbecue is...
I've never had Korean barbecue.
There was this one place I used to go that would give that had like spicy Korean, like I think wings, and it was just a really good taste. Super spicy, had some sweet. Good. No, it was back in Texas.
Oh, okay. Korean wings are like a very special treat to me.
My mouth's watering.
Every once in a while, Paul will be out of town, and I'll just call this place. Crazy Pepper.
You're like, bring everything you got.
it's two order of wings.
Here's my debit card. Bring it all.
And it's just, it's so, I eat like 25 wings. It's so good.
We should go to House.
Dude.
I already got a reservation.
When you brought it up for my birthday, I immediately looked it up and they were all booked up for the whole weekend.
I tried to find us one at 11 o'clock at night too. Like, let's just go.
You know what I did recently? Me and Cool Greg, his birthday is on the 23rd, right?
Right.
Which is like fucking
close. Tomorrow?
God, 2 days away. Oh, it's Friday. Are we gonna all party? Let's
try. Oh no, no.
Oh.
I was
too late to plan something. My birthday, May 26th. I looked up online what the middle of those days is. April 9th.
Uh-huh.
So that's when we're going to House of Prime Rib.
Wow.
There you go. April 9th.
I'm very excited.
How'd you call him?
Are we invited? What's up? What's going on? Eventually pops up
the
triangle.
You want me to open up the thing? Have more people do it?
I mean, we can call up Gary Winter right now and he'll go.
Oh, yeah, Gary would
go. He'd be so happy to hear from us.
Awesome.
Called me on his Apple Vision Pro.
What did you see? This is what it'll look like when I die, Mike. Holy shit,
it's a scary image.
It's a scary image.
Did you get a...
It's
where
a
did
FaceTime.
That... On your phone.
On my phone, it says Gary Wynn is FaceTiming you.
Can you FaceTime him really quick?
Me?
Yeah.
Or him? You?
No, oh, you. Yeah. FaceTime him.
Him?
Yeah,
Gary.
So that I can see what it looks like.
Oh, okay. I'll text him. I'll just say, are you busy?
No, just FaceTime him. He'll answer, he won't answer. Done. If he
you
answers...
know he wants to show that shit off. No, but he may not be in the world yet.
But... Oh,
he may not be in depth.
That's great. That's where you get me.
Yeah.
You're right. You're right. You don't think he's got that thing on his face at all times? Giant battery pack in his ass?
Because you get excited about that tech for a week and then you forget and it just becomes another thing that lays around.
I don't know, man. I don't know. I try to pull out my devices as much as possible.
I do want a MetaQuest 3 only so I could...
You don't have a MetaQuest 3?
No. I have a 2.
Wow.
What did she tell me right here?
Andy, see, that's why you're talking, because, like, you haven't experienced the 3.
I thought we didn't get him a 3?
No, everybody else got a 3.
Let's take Greg. Greg's not going to use it. Don't worry about Greg. He doesn't even know what day it is today.
I wish I could live in it.
I mean, when they become this, we're living in it.
Oh, 100%.
This is all... But when? When? How many years?
The X-Beam. Is that what it's called?
I think so, I believe.
Is that what it was called?
I think so.
Or was the X being the little controller part? I mean, that was the glimpse of, like, it's so hard for me not to be wearing the
X-Reel.
X-Reel, thank you. X-Beam is the little controller. It's so hard not for me not to be wearing it constantly.
Chop up the X.
Like, I started working it wearing them here, and you guys immediately were like, look at him.
I saw you wearing one.
I thought it was cool as shit, bro.
Yeah. I think that might have been Roger.
No, it was a lot of pointing and laughing.
Roger. How would you just blame it on Roger?
You might have to touch that one.
I think that may have been Roger.
Let me touch this first. I like when I get Roger. Because you're going to hear it through the doorway and you just know you're like, I got him. I got his ass.
I don't know what the fuck I'm doing.
You open door number 1. Complete.
We did it.
Commencing test of augmented research specimen.
Test.
I believe this is it. Yeah, this part is kind of hard to, like, figure out what the fuck is happening.
Also, we're not listening.
Well, no, I don't think it's about listening. It's just, like, understanding where your two teams are on the map. And it's a maze, you know? It's a crazy maze puzzle.
I wasn't listening. I can be honest about it.
Like, maybe they show you, like, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and they show where Cloud and Barrett are on floor 2.
Like, you see, I'm 4 over here. I'm over by 4. Am I supposed to be going to 1?
Well, yeah, you got to go to 1 now.
I know I'm supposed to turn all these things on.
Well, you got to go to 2 to now.
Right, no, he's got to go to 1. They open the door.
Where the hell is 1? 1's, like, way down there.
No, you don't got to go to the door.
Should I go to 4? I've already been to 4.
Yeah, what do we do?
Just go to 1.
Switch 4.
Oh, kill those guys. No one in chat is saying what to do. Not that we would trust you. Go to 4.
Keep it up, man.
Oh, okay.
4 is the way forward. Switch back. Hit switch number 4.
Oh, they'll switch in the door.
But again, these kids are fucking liars, you know?
Well, now the problem is I gotta run.
Bullshit.
You gotta use the phone.
Star Wars The Acolyte Show, June 5th.
What's that?
It's their new show about, like, the Sith or something.
A lot of Star Wars.
A lot of bad Star Wars. Let's call it out. Let's call it what it is.
I'll say this. I talked about Alicia Keys, and I ate my words.
You did.
But I'm willing to say it about Star Wars, okay?
Enough.
I've had enough.
I mean...
Okay? We can put that on pause.
I felt the same until I watched Andor.
Okay, yeah, but, like, that's a lot of commitment, you know? You gotta turn it on, you gotta watch past episode 1. Oof.
Dude, episode 1's awesome. It's all awesome.
Yeah, it was
all
right.
It's got so much good dialogue.
I know, but I'm just so burned, you know?
I know.
And that's the movie that I, like love the most. That it's connected to.
This
Rogue
was
One.
A good idea,
oh, remember when
right?
he got in
the
Hives?
Gary Whitty worked on that. Paul worked on that.
Remember what?
When he get when the Hives watching the other one, not Rogue One.
Oh, that was bad. Ooh, Hives right here.
Is that you? he kept it in the hate.
Psycho.
That's what happened. When you I don't know what psycho is.
It eats at you. It eats the way it's
in. And it happened to Kevin. Yeah. That's what happened.
It's like whenever they show like a racist person and like how they look all old and beaten up, it's like, this is what hate does to a person.
That's what hate does. That's what happened to Kevin. On our side. You should be able to get in. Kevin had to keep the hate in his heart and it fucked him up.
It really fucked
him up. I thought Kenobi was okay. I thought season two of Mandalorian was like more enjoyable than season one. But I skipped on Book of Boba Fett. I tried episode one, I was like, this is just not working.
Yeah, let me tell you what. Too much. That season one was tough.
Kenobi had cool moments, but I didn't love the show overall. Remember that little girl, remember young Leia running away from the show? That weird chase scene?
Didn't watch it, didn't watch it.
Fucking what a joke. But then they made a good one with Andor, and it was like, oh, make more of that. Season two is about to come out. Or they just wrap filming it.
Oh my god, is this it? No, this isn't it. God damn
it. You gotta wonder, like, if you're Hojo right now, like, what the fuck are they doing?
Yeah, where, are these guys good?
Watching them on the camera, like, they're going that way?
But also, like, Hojo should be, like, running. You know what I mean? Like, if I was Hojo, we'd be on the next escape pod out of here.
I don't think you escape pods out of, like, buildings.
You never know what the Broncos got. Yeah. Oh, there. You hear that? Oh, he said run. I thought he was going to step up and, like, shoot. Oh, no, it's not. No, it's not. It's Rhodey on a motorcycle?
No, he died.
Oh, what is that thing? It had the head of the motorcycle.
Oh, you thought it was the front of the bike. Yeah, the round red.
I
yeah, yeah.
Rhodey was coming in on the bike.
Yeah, his name's not Rhodey, but. I thought it was Ronnie, and it was neither that. It's Roche.
Roche?
We thought it was Roche.
Fiera Roche.
Ferrero.
Fiera.
I love a good Fiera Roche.
Man.
Roche.
I love like, those.
Dude, you put one of those, we got a problem.
I legitimately felt like I was a millionaire when my mom would get a gift of Ferrero Roche as a kid.
Man, dude.
I was like, dude, this is the richest shit I've ever
eaten. Those Andes mints, bro. You get those Andes mints, all of a sudden you just be
sad. Now you've gone too far.
Yeah, I don't know.
Don't fuck with Andes mints, bro.
I don't know about Andes. I mean, they're fine, but like, I don't put it on the same level as a Ferrero Roche. Get that hazelnut.
Ferrero Roche is one of those. My mom would get some boss or something.
Big gift, but yeah, big Valentine's Day.
And it's one of those things, every single time, they're like, oh, fuck, I shouldn't.
Here we go.
I've already taken too many.
Fucking seven later.
You feel bad as you're doing it, but, like, you don't stop.
You black out, you're like, I ate 11 in the last 2 hours.
And it's like, surely she won't notice four have gone missing.
Well, it's so easy to upset your tummy.
Oh, really? Yeah. Oh, it's never upset my tummy.
Well, when you eat 30 of them, you know what I mean?
I should bring my ice cream in and have you guys chase it.
Anything can hurt your tummy if you eat 30 of something. Except
you
rice.
You know, one time, me and my sister...
Rice makes my belly hurts, though, because I ate so much of it. It expands. You know,
last time we had spices, that fucking rice was incredible.
Dude, I mean, what day is it today? It's Wednesday.
Aren't like you going to see a movie today?
Yeah, we have a movie tonight.
Oh my god, it's not a bad plan.
No, that's a lot of driving, man. That's a lot of back and forth. We're gonna be
me and Kevin.
That's at least an hour of traffic.
We could come to your house, shut up the mess network.
I don't want you anywhere near my technology or my house.
I you know what? If you look at the day to day. Our day really ends at 3:15. Mike, look at the day today. See what's coming in.
Oh, it has no weaknesses.
I see it.
So we can leave early. Go get.
I'm bashing at work. Get spices.
I mean, he doesn't want us going into his home.
Well, we get it for him.
Damn, it's got no weaknesses.
No, it's not cheap.
Well, I mean, no, he gets
it. Well, I mean, how would that be us giving him a gift?
Well, I mean, we're there.
Okay.
It's got no weaknesses, Mike.
It's not afraid.
Got really fucked up though with fire and lightning when I gave it to him.
Oh, okay.
The business of that and the thing immediately dropped.
Yeah, they're watching Advent Calendar, that's right.
Yeah, Advent Calendar.
I gotta watch Dune.
Mike and Andy, I heard that Advent Children had spoilers for the story of Final Fantasy VII. Well, I mean, that's why I'm beating it right now.
Yeah.
Duh.
Oh, Red 13th, riding that thing.
Keep talking.
You go, Red 13th. But I was also talking like this. It's like, Red 13th, riding that thing.
But also, Chad, do you think that, like, that's going to matter? Like, they probably switched off. They changed all that shit anyway, man. Yeah.
Fighting down circuits and stuff. Oh, big fireball. This is something straight out of the Matrix.
Yeah, the little flying.
Yeah, those flying scary things.
Flying bug robot.
Those things would scare you. MSC. That did work, family.
I'm gonna go check on Barrett.
Again, you triumph.
Creepo, man.
He's happy about this.
Creepo. Got cool glasses, though.
Yes.
These idiots. What the fuck?
They're locked in.
Kicking the door.
Then we are ready to proceed to the next stage.
Uh-oh. Oh, he's
look,
gone,
here's
man.
My thing, Mike. Can
yeah,
you pause
take
this?
Take a minute.
Just pause it. Just pause it real quick.
Yeah, Sethy.
Because it's like a larger conversation.
Oh, okay. Let's talk about it.
When we were watching the Xbox thing with Phil.
Yes.
And Sarah Bond and Matt Booty.
Uh-huh.
And we talked about, like, Xbox clearly, like, they don't want to be the big cinematic first person thing
correct.
That PlayStation
yeah.
Is doing.
That
you know?
Third person action yeah. Adventure cinematic.
We're
going to
fill a different void. Yeah. But, like, look. This is as independent as a voice that you'll hear, right? Yeah. I play games on PC.
Plays everywhere.
I grew up playing on Xbox. I grew up playing on PlayStation. I love it all.
Yeah.
I want Xbox to pop off.
Pop off.
How can you not be an Xbox player looking at this and going like, we got to get one of these, man.
When do we get one?
Why can't we
Andy,
have one of these?
I am blown away that, like, if you asked anyone on planet Earth that's an Xbox player, they would have to say, yes, I want one of these. I want many of these.
And when I say these, I just mean, like, this, like,
high
they
production.
Zoom in that face, and yeah. It looks incredible, and this, like, it's just...
And why is Xbox as the brand said, we don't want to do that? No, you have to do that. This is what's selling. This is what's pushing the medium. Make this.
It hurts me.
That's what Indiana Jones should be. That's
yeah.
What Perfect
and
Dark
it will
be,
hopefully.
Be. Yeah, but I don't know.
I don't know about Perfect Dark. I feel
know.
More confident. I feel way more confident about Indy.
Maybe.
I don't know what the fuck's happening with Perfect Dark, dude.
Yeah, well, I mean, that's problems.
But then I also look at Perfect Dark, and it's like, that's not a franchise that anybody's like, we need a new yeah. One of those.
I agree.
You know
I
what
agree.
I mean? Like,
I agree with it. I agree.
Just breaks agree my heart. It. Hey, Greg.
Hi.
Hi, Greg.
Talking about being an Xbox fan, looking at like Final Fantasy
yeah.
And being like, why can't we get one of these? I want one of these.
Why can't we have that?
Is this on? Can they hear me, you think?
Yeah, I think.
Oh,
so.
I don't know.
Put a one in the chat if you can hear. If
you hear
Greg
Greg talking in this microphone, does it
can.
Sound clear? Does it sound clear? Does it yeah. Sound clear? They, well, that's behind. They're saying Greg. Does it sound clear?
They're
one,
just,
one,
yeah, they're
one.
Just seeing you. Hey, chat, can you hear Greg?
Yes, they can.
They can.
Yeah, you're good.
Yeah, I'm sorry. You're lamenting that Xbox fans don't have Final Fantasy?
Yeah.
Just any good.
Well, like,
a
game like this, like it's got to hurt for an Xbox fan to be like, what? When do we get one of these?
I mean, I didn't even time this bit. I came in here to get my PlayStation so I could play Helldivers because they don't have that either.
That's a hot game right now.
You know what I mean? Xbox fans, like,
it sucks, man.
Andy, I don't mean to say this because, you know, I love Phil and I love the Xbox team and I love the Xcast, but we might be at the point where PC gamers have gone up the feeding chain above Xbox players.
Wow.
And we might have to redirect all our hate to Xbox.
Because, wow.
You know what I mean? Because,
wow.
Andy, you've been on this PC hate train with me the entire time.
No, I have not. That's
I've been Batman, you've been Robin. I've yep. Been Laurel.
You think I'm an under?
I've been Laurel, you've been Hardy. But, I mean, it's time. Maybe it's time we flip the script, go after these Xbox games.
What did Laurel and Hardy do?
They were, like,
the Hardy Boys?
Comedians. Nope, no. Well, no.
The Hardy Boys.
There's Jeff and Matt, the Hardy Boys from yep. Wrestling, and then there's the Hardy Boys detectives.
Detectives
and then,
or what
yeah,
else? And Laurel was one of them.
Laurel and Hardy are two different people, and they were like silent era comedians, like black and white thing.
Oh.
Nick grew up watching them.
Oh, okay, gotcha.
Greg's very
not even a giggle. A fucking, I just nailed Nick. Nothing out of either of you. You guys are fucking.
I thought it was a good one.
We haven't seen Nick all day, so you know,
yeah,
Nick's not
I
high
forgot
on
he
mine
existed.
Right now. when Nick doesn't come in, we don't think about it.
If it's right there.
That's not true. My girl goes, I miss Nick. That's not true at all.
But when he doesn't come in, I get to say stuff like that.
We don't think about it. Anyway, like, so I just wanted to spill that. Like,
I feel that.
I wanted to drop that, but I also didn't want to kick the hornet's nest during that one reaction thing. Yeah. We're amongst friends now.
Yeah.
And also, here's another thing. Look, like, I'm kind of annoying when it comes to this, but like, when there's a lot of annoying Xbox fans, I'm like, shut the fuck up. Y'all don't got
games. You don't
games.
Have it. You don't
when there's a lot
games.
Of annoying PlayStation fans, I'm like, shut the fuck up. Y'all are annoying.
Yeah.
Like, I get annoyed on whenever.
Go
play a remaster.
But that chat was filled with, like, a lot of Xbox hate and a lot of, like, Sony loyalists and stuff.
Yeah, uh-huh.
And it's just like, I just need them to have a win. To,
they
like,
need a win. Desperately.
To shut up the annoying PlayStation fans a little bit.
Needs to be Fable. Fable's the one you look at.
Oh.
Fable is the one to bring us to the light. Playground Games and everything that they've accomplished and the tech that they have. Playground Games.
Kojima better bring it with his horror game.
Kojima, you better bring it. Kojima's beyond Xbox, but Fable has to be the one. Because unfortunately, you know, as much as I love Hellblade and all the things they're doing, it's too dark and gritty and scary. People want a little more fun, a little more levity to it, I think. And so I think.
Well, it's also got the massive production levels, but it's also, we're not making a big game. This is going to be a 6, 7, 10-hour experience.
Yeah, you know? But like people are going to be whispering in your ear and shit, and like that's cool.
Yeah,
like,
I mean it's going to look incredible, out, but it's not going to be like a system seller, you know?
Yeah. Fable could be.
I hope, man.
If Fable's hot, Fable could be.
I hope. I really hope so.
That's Sethy. He's got the mom.
Genova. Jehovah's Witness.
Uh-oh.
Yes, we got it to work.
We're moving. So what's going on here? He's got that lady that could, I don't even know. You know what I mean? Mom, freak, monster, who knows? Oh no, you can't let her go by herself.
The elevators are safe.
Oh, thank God. You know, Aerith's kind of important. You can't be letting her go solo.
If you say so.
Of course.
Everyone has to be tied to Aerith at this
moment. It's like a little, it's like babysitting. Like,
exactly.
You cannot let this baby go free.
Yeah, it's VIP status right now.
You're gonna let this baby cross the street right now? You're crazy.
Holy cow.
It's middle of Times Square.
No, something tells me that we aren't. Call it a hunch.
I hear something.
I get a baby. I'm always carrying the baby.
You had never carried a baby at Greg's birthday party, and you looked very...
But you held that baby.
You didn't hold it right. You held it in a very weird way, and we're like, Mike, that's not how you usually hold a baby. I mean, you're innovating, though.
I'm just scooping babies up now. Watch out.
Mike was holding baby Ben, and, like, baby Ben's butt was, like, kind of, like... His legs were out and he was face out. I was like, Mike, it's usually like they're facing you and their butt is sitting here and you're holding them up.
Yeah, but I was like showing them off like it was a parrot.
A parrot. Okay. Man, back together. I've never seen anybody hold a parrot like that either. But okay.
Wait, wait to the roof. There's an elevator just over there.
Like a football, yeah, pretty much. Discretion. Let the stiff arm somewhere.
Just in case somebody tries to come up and steal this baby, yeah, I'm on it, bro.
Yeah.
Where are we going, team? What are we doing? Find the others, got it done.
When in reality, Ben was way more exposed that way. Like, he's not hooked in anywhere. He's just sitting.
Never know. We came from this way, so I assume we're going back that way, right? Yeah, we got to. Right?
I wasn't listening. I was thinking about the baby. Down the tunnel, Mike. This is showtime.
Back the way we came, though? Oh, maybe.
It's bullshit.
Well, okay then. Looks like the elevator is working.
It appears Hojo's done having his fun.
Glad to hear he enjoyed the show.
I'm going to play on performance, Casper. But I agree. I don't think performance mode looks amazing. It's still like 1080 for the most part.
We're back again.
Maybe lower. I need to see Digital Foundry do like the pixel count. And then
he was definitely up in there.
Quality mode is 1440p up-res to 4K. Pretty sure.
Who would?
We may find out soon.
Let's go.
I mean, we're gonna find out. That's Sethy over there, bro. He's out there. Up with this purple goop. Is that dripping off of her? Is that coming off his footsteps? It's gotta be dripping off of her, right?
The president's office, and then the roof.
Wait. Once we get in that elevator, there's no turning back. We're ready.
Yeah, where do you think we're going?
The elevator back there can take us down to the central terminal again. Now's the time for any unfinished business.
No, bro, we ain't. We got no business. We got.
I ain't trying to get that special material on that one ledge.
Same story.
Yeah, what are they telling?
Everything goes quiet when Greg is starting the curse, and you're like, what is going on over there?
I'm excited.
I want to know all about it. Do we follow the footsteps?
Yeah, of course.
Okay.
We got no other business.
The goop?
69th floor, what's up?
What if Sethi's fake? This lady got out all by herself and is stomping around. He's got to be real. I think there's no way he's not real, right? Oh, that's definitely the president's office. Two doors, always the president's office.
Where the hell is that bastard hiding?
Aunt Sephiroth?
Wait, I can
hear
something.
Are like nowhere close to the end. We still got a ways, man.
Get out of town, bro. What are you talking about?
I'm pretty sure, yeah. Because I was about to ask you I was going to ask you about something that happens here that I thought you'd already done.
What? Hey. Oh, shit. Someone got chucked out the window, bro.
Fuck, yeah. Like an Ace Ventura.
I love Ace Ventura.
Threw him out the window of that hotel.
Remember when he got the spears on the legs? Ah! Ah! Where he crawled out of the rhino's butt. So good.
If he goes until 5 today, he can do it.
I mean, we can do it.
That's tough.
We got all day, bro. Mike and Andy together, bro, spending time together.
I don't have a podcast.
Maybe some mesh network. You know what I mean?
Please help me. Hey!
Oh, I'm going to help this guy?
Please. What a joke.
I'm about to drop you like you dropped the plate on Sector 7, dude. What's happening here?
Help me. Well, well. I'll give you all the money you want. I have killed plenty of it.
Damn.
Step on his fingers.
Thing is, I don't want your money.
Please.
Oh.
Brute strength, dude.
Just let me live. Everything you want can be yours.
I'm a man of modest dreams. Dropping you from 70 stories up would get me damn near to good.
But not all the way. You want something more, don't you?
More than this right here? Talk to me again like you know me.
Oh. Oh.
Barrett, stop it!
Nobody wants this. Well. Is there good saving this guy? Yeah, dude, this guy's bad to the bone. We're not saving him.
gonna get on TV and tell them. Tell them what you did to Sector 7. That it was you who killed all those people. Then, you're gonna tell them the truth about Avalanche. That Avalanche ain't Wu-Tai or anybody's puppet. That Avalanche fights for the people, the planet. That we fight to hold Shinra to account for its crimes. That is Avalanche. The filthy sewer rats.
Nah, he ain't doing
down
that.
A Goliath. You tell him that.
Is that really all you want? For your names to be cleared? That is what matters most to you? More than shutting down the reactors? Than the future of the planet itself?
Ooh.
Damn. You're lying to yourself even now.
God.
Truth, justice, honor, freedom. Vain indulgences everyone. Picture it. Picture a world without Shinra. Without Mako Energy. A stagnant, impotent world.
Oh, so impotent.
Now picture a natural disaster. Who would help the people? Help them recover and rebuild? You? With their old world ruined, will they thank you for the new? I'm going to give you a chance.
He's got to chuck that sword at him.
To consider what your principles are truly worth. But bear in mind that time is of the essence.
And what about you, Mr. President? What are your vaunted principles?
What principles? Did you understand even a single word of what I told you? I know what I want, and I take it. I take advantage of whatever I can, and discard that which I cannot. There is no room for sentiment or guilt.
Shinra on the gun. Oh! Who killed him? It's Sethi!
Sethi is real, Mike.
Oh my!
You son of a bitch!
Yep, the whispers are gonna have none of that. You don't get to touch him. No shit!
Barret!
Bro.
Cloud's fucked up, bro. I might become this band.
What does that mean?
One of them, Sethi's just so hot. He's so hot.
I don't know if that happens when you become bad, though.
You never know.
Then you have to start off being hot. You don't just grow a long silver mane.
Become bad. I'm glad you get that. What?
Bro.
Uh-oh.
The source of everything.
Steve's
the source, bro.
Oh?
What is this?
Genova. Genova Dreamweaver.
Hold. Watch this. Watch what I feel. You're gonna like this.
Oh, yeah.
You like that?
What's the fucking weakness right here? Nothing, dog. But
where do you see that?
Weakness is status ailment.
Oh, and why it's empty? Okay.
You would see like lightning if it was weak to lightning or whatever. But you could still use like lightning and shit like that, and it'll still like do well.
Genova the Dreamweaver? That's a badass name, though. Play him with my super fire.
Ooh, a Firaga.
Chopped off a tentacle already. What you know about
it? It said that the fire damage was reduced, I believe.
Okay. Even with the thunder, then.
Thundara. Oh, they're critical.
Oh, was it really critical?
Well, I'm seeing their punches being critical. Yeah, just, I say you just keep on fucking going for these pennies.
I'm gonna hit him with the Blizz. Well, he doesn't even have that anymore, you know what I mean? They're gone. He cut them all off already.
Oh, yeah.
Now go into Tifa mode. Hit him with my favorite flying drop kick, dive kick.
I was saying, this one was also a dude punisher mode as Cloud.
Oh,
switch from operator mode to punisher. You just boom, boom, boom.
it's all fine.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'll take care of them. Tagging out.
Let's do this.
Need to hurt. Stop it!
Aim at something else.
She's got you in a big force field of purple poison.
So you tell me this isn't Sephy?
I mean, even if I knew, I wouldn't tell you, but I don't know. This Dreamweaver, so, you know. I feel like you're just maybe in a... You're not really in this location.
Oh, okay, okay.
Sephy's skull face looked at you and teleported you. Teleported your mind.
Kind of a sexy skull face, yeah. Too.
Beautiful jawline.
One that you think to yourself, would I make out with that?
Mm-hmm. You touch that sharp chin. Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, Cloud's looking real bad. Here we go. Big heal.
Watch that. Get out of it. Get out of it. Look at that backstab.
Get him!
And that wasn't that bad.
Why don't you
lead
the way?
Bam, big Blizzara. Oh, it said reduce still.
She just took 600 to the face.
Ooh, nice, critical.
Oh, I got locked shit, up, but it won't cool. Let me out.
That was cool.
Hit him with the triple slash.
Because remember, Genova's his mom.
Whose mom, though?
Sephiroth.
Cloud or Seth?
Sephiroth.
Okay. Damn.
This is someone's mother?
Yeah.
No more playing
that. That's someone, too. Crazy like that. No, someone's working up to it.
You're as good as dead.
Watch the help on Cloud.
Oh, I got him! Kevin called him, bro. He said, you better watch yourself, fool.
Yeah, this is a hard boss fight, I remember.
Hit him with the summon. Call an Ifrit.
Get him.
Burn it. Crimson Dive is just a cool fucking.
Cool word.
I'm gonna name a bar after that. That'd be a cool Final Fantasy themed bar, right? Like a little dive bar, Crimson Dive.
I love it for the Crimson Dive.
Yeah. We sell like shots of materia, but it's in an orb, you know?
We just get buzz bombs. We get buzz bombs.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
And, like, these are special edition buzz bombs.
Oh, yeah.
You're not finding this at the corner store. No, no, you gotta come to us.
There's a blue one, here's a purple one.
Let's finish this.
Immune to everything, bro.
That's crazy.
You gotta hit the tentacles, hit the tennies.
Right after I cure some people.
Oh yeah, I thought he could zip to these suckers.
Couldn't see them.
Oh yeah. Tear these suckers apart. Woo-wee!
Gotta get the most out of my summon before he's gotta go. Oh, there's a lot of them.
Yeah, a lot more left.
How many more?
Every letter, bro.
Yeah. You're just a G right now. Oh, this summon better hit the other tentacles and not just the immune fucking Genova. Kevin, last night I was talking about... Nice.
Ball, bro, and we're
huge. Last night I was talking about, back in the day, just hiding from Jehovah's Witnesses or like Mormons.
Yeah.
And just what a crazy concept of like a knock at the door and all your family like, shut the fuck up, everybody, yeah. Shut up.
Everyone, no,
don't look through the blinds. You're gonna move the blinds. You're gonna, like, it was like a horror
movie.
They're
gonna know we're here. They're gonna know we're here.
Crazy.
It was like a scary movie. It's still me, Mike.
Hit them fucking peeking out the window, just waiting.
Yeah, it's so
okay,
scary.
They're gone. They're gone. Yeah. All right, just everybody back to normal.
You know, that shit doesn't fly nowadays. You can't just be walking up to people's doors.
No, absolutely not, no.
Nobody, that shit doesn't fly no more. Now people got rings, too, so they got the ring TV on you, and they're like, yo, what the fuck?
I mean, dog, people don't even answer phones anymore.
People don't even answer phones anymore, dude. We've gone full isolation mode. Don't call me, don't look at me, don't even get a hold of me.
All right, here we go. Now you hit him. Now you hit Genova.
This guy with my...
Oh, yes, this is good. Big chunk of dew.
Oh, watch out. Don't get hit by the goo.
Black goo from Severance. Oh, the song.
This is straight out of Stranger Things type vibe.
So cool.
Staying in the pocket, doing the dirt.
You're just getting shit on.
Do your dirt, do your work.
Destroyed.
By the time, right there.
Nah, he's still alive.
Okay, he's still alive. He's pretty fucked up.
Staying in the pocket.
Look, I love the confidence in which you say staying in the pocket, but it's like, it's not a good idea.
Stay in the
tentacles, tentacles.
I'm coming.
Behind me. Last one, A.
Oh,
nah, there's a B. There was a B. There was a B.
Smacked myself. Man. This is sick.
So badass.
This is so sick.
Multiple tentacles again, I think.
Just go away.
I think you're about to pop out. Oh my God, he's got headshot.
Holy shot to back.
Nasty.
Hit him with another limit breaker, bro.
You don't want to save it for half a second? Oh, nope, there you go.
Nah, man, I'm all
now switch to Punisher mode and just fucking wail. Oh yeah, dog.
Big time.
I bet you. Oh, I thought Tebow's gonna have her limit as well. But never mind.
Nah,
taking forever. This is huge. Little focus thrust right here. Oh yeah, baby.
You're done. Oh, no,
49.
No.
Nick Bosa.
You think Barrett's okay?
You're pretty good, kid. Such a puppy. Nick Mako eyes, Mike.
What's up? He don't speak? Oh, he's got his helicopter out of here.
The Dementors.
Friendlies. Oh, this is our helicopter out.
Was that the Avalanche logo? That's cool.
Yeah, they also have a weird dog. Oh my God, what is this guy doing? He's flying! Motherfucker's goddamn flying, dude!
David Blaine, Mike.
What is he doing?
Dude, street magic.
What?
Oh, yeah, see, he's fine.
Are we sure we're not just all high off the Mako, bro? This could be a Mako dream.
The Dementor.
Turns out to just
stepped
be a,
in.
It's a gunshot from the president. All of this has been Mako highs.
No.
Barrett technically shot the president.
That's not true. Johnny's gonna come out of the dog. So what, you see what they said about the death? What
did he say?
Like, it wasn't meant to be. Like, it's...
Thanks.
Oh yeah, the whispers. Yeah, yeah. This wasn't meant to be.
The whispers stepped in, dude.
Because they said it would have been orphaned, and then who was gonna watch the daughter? Me.
I don't
come a Mando, I mean, situation. I got a kid.
That's
now?
Not what they're trying to get across to you. They don't want you to get you. They don't want to get you stressed about having to adopt a baby. It's just like the ghost that wasn't destiny. That wasn't fate. Like the ghosts are stepping in. Like this wasn't supposed to happen.
That was like when we rode that. Batman ride together, and the kid was like, I'm the fastest in the West. And the ghost stepped in and was like, I'm going to make sure these two kids don't die right now.
Yeah.
There was more than two of you there.
Was that a three-man ride? Was it a three-man ride? No, I think it's two. It was two on each side, right?
Yeah.
On each side.
Well, yeah, but like me and Tim were there too.
Well, yeah, but he said it to me and Andy.
Yeah.
All right.
He said, I'm the fastest.
Weren't we like facing each other? He said it to all of us.
Yeah.
I just remember thinking, I'm going to die.
This is it for me.
I love
it. It'll be a big breaking story at fucking Six Flags over here.
Andy, I got bullied into getting a flu shot today.
Uh-huh.
Oh, that's good.
And my arm hurts.
Oh, yeah.
And that wicked COVID number two, this new flu thing going around, is fucking people up, bro. Big Mike's definitely got it. Your ass is, you know.
It'd be fine.
Wicked COVID?
Oh, shit.
This
guy's up here. Why are we chasing him?
Sephiroth!
Said it for the first time. What if he just humps the body off this? Oh, they don't want you. What?
Well.
Number two?
Oh.
Little wink.
And he looks like him too.
Does he?
Damn, that's some crazy stuff right there, y'all. That's some crazy stuff right there, y'all.
Look at that Avalanche logo. So
everyone
sick.
Okay?
Hey, get your man.
No, I didn't.
He got away.
About time we made our escape.
Was that Joshua? That's my brother Joshua.
You thought you were getting out of here, bro. It's gotta be Big H, huh?
And who the fuck do you think it is?
Rowdy?
Shit.
No.
Yeah, who's in the
shit? I love how Roche turned into Rowdy, then Rowdy
like
from
Rowdy.
Kevin.
I like Rowdy. Reno.
Yeah,
it's goddamn Reno.
No, but it's also handsome boy Rufus.
Oh, we haven't seen this guy yet.
Oh.
We have not seen this.
I thought that's who you're talking about. The handsome.
No. We only know about Rude and Reno.
This is the handsome guy I was talking about. Rufus.
Oh, I was talking about the board member that looked like you.
Oh, no, I don't know who that is.
If it ain't Rufus Shinra, heir to the throne.
The son.
Yep. Rufus Shinra?
Yeah, dog.
Who's his father? Not the president, right?
Yeah.
He's the president of Shinra's son?
Yeah.
Wow.
The son of the president.
You think it's crazy the fact that he lifted his arm while there's a helicopter? Like, you know what I mean? Like, I don't care how far it is. It's one of those things you gotta crouch a little.
Finish off the family here and now.
Take Aerith and get out of here.
Gotta shut this down ASAP, y'all. You gotta get out and look at a giant.
So many buckles.
I'll buy you guys some time.
Dog?
Yeah, he's got the giant panther dog.
I heard dung.
Giant dog.
I'm asking you. Please.
Now this game still looks so good.
Music's so good too.
Oh, fine. Have it your way then.
It's not a new game?
But you better be right behind us.
This came out in 2019?
And it came out on PS4 too.
I mean, it's like 4 years old, five, yeah.
Watch me chop these guys in half.
2020, sorry. Oh, what a shot.
Yeah.
That's a little screensaver right there.
Oh. Hello, Rufus.
You're a soldier, aren't you? Which, of course, would mean that I own
you. Oh!
Ex-soldier. I quit.
Secure the others.
Where are you
going? I'm not going anywhere. I gotta stay up, but my legs are.
Just the two of us.
It's a new thing. We just haven't been on a couch in a long time, you know? It's getting my hammies are tight.
Let's get this over.
Oh, that's it's a new setup, new guy. Dark Star? What a sick name for this panther dog. Are you kidding me?
That's more like a jack, you know?
Oh, he just shot you.
I'm trying to go Punisher mode so I can... My god. Oh my god!
Oh my god! You're getting combo.
Andy, do you know the button?
Well, I was trying to parry, but I don't know.
I don't know how to parry this one.
I don't think I'm hitting it fast enough. Probably the HDMI
switch. I haven't seen Mike parry like,
we didn't parry since the beginning of the game. We parried a couple of times and that was about it. When you're on easy mode, there's no such thing as parrying.
Yeah, you're right. You're right. I should just swing away, Meryl.
Yes. Hey, remember when we did a Signs watch along?
Oh, yeah.
What an insane idea.
That was wild. When was that?
That was something. When was it?
That was in the pandemic. Like, because Blessing had never watched it. We were like, oh, you got to watch Signs, dude.
You like it?
Yeah, I think you did. Yeah.
Settle down now.
I'll end this.
I'm surprised he agreed to it, honestly.
Oh, you're gonna take out Darkstar first. That's a smart move. Take out the weaker of the two.
Oh, I was trying to go off and
Rune says understood.
Not at all. You're making me sweat. Good thing I came prepared.
He's like Two-Face, Kevin.
Oh.
What? That's so cool. Yo, Rufus is kind of that dude, bro.
He's lit, yeah.
Why is no one helping you? Oh, they left. They left.
Yeah, they had to go. Air's number one priority. Top priority. She's got to go.
Man, I'm glad she's safe and nothing will ever happen to her.
Fuck you, Darkstar, bitch.
Gotta back up.
Just like Top Gun, like.
Now it's just the two of us. Oh, he's got a lot of coins to use. He tricked you. How sick was that, though?
Let's make it a night.
And the shotgun shells in the side of the sword were so freaking cool, man.
Where were we?
That move is just so badass.
Yeah. Oh man, they nailed it with this guy. Like Reno and Rude were cool, but we didn't really see them do like epic crazy stuff like this. This is insane behavior. Smoke bomb you.
Smoke bomb me. He's like a Metal Gear boss, man.
He's definitely a Metal Gear boss, Andy. Oh, you got him. Sit down, dude.
No holding back. Here it comes.
Oh, too far away.
Yeah, I want that to get there no matter.
Man, he parries that non-stop.
Oh,
I basically just have to hit him with just like
your limit breaks
with other moves and shit. Oh, he's reloading. That's when you want to pressure.
See you, dude. Pick your poison. You want to die tonight?
I could end this here and now.
No, not quite. Tonight marks a new.
A no look exit.
A new beginning for Shinra. Oh man. It's like we're at the tower. It's like we're at the pillar all over again, man. One arm with a glove on.
And you know that sword is like 60 pounds.
Who's there to save you? Who's there to save you?
Best girl.
Oh my gosh, she's incredible.
You gotta be better than this. If you're gonna play the hero,
Come on, bro.
Come on, dude.
Come on! The best, dude.
God damn, this game is good, y'all. On their own.
You've seen them both in action. You know they can. Besides... What was that?
What more could happen? The whole roof is exploding!
I hope so.
Damn it.
Hey.
Screw it. We gotta go pay. Hey. What, Red? Get down!
It's a robot. Oh my god.
Terminator.
Oh, it's on this. It's on another elevator. Oh, it shot the rope out. Are you kidding me?
Everything's cool.
Show me something, Wedge.
Yeah, what's wet?
Barrett!
Pizza slice.
Yeah, what? Pizza slice, what do you think you're doing?
Not again!
Oh, the Whispers want none of that. They're trying to guide him to where he needs to be.
You can't. Tifa and Barrett too. I'm sorry, Cloud.
Was it Destiny?
Just tell me that I made a difference.
Fucking Beaver, dude.
Damn. What happened with your brony boy then? Still alive.
Still in one piece?
Yeah, somehow.
Robot. Yeah, but see, the robot can't get through the door. Oh my god, that would be a sight. It would be like that would.
You think the robot should have sit down and go, thanks to me, close, open the door faster.
Oh, it just went through the walls, of course. Yeah, that's exactly what it was gonna do. So badass, dude. Let's go level by level. It's goddamn Die Hard.
Open wide. And suck on this.
Steal. Yup.
Gotta take out the things.
Yup, of course. Man, so many cool robots. And cool monsters in this
variety
game.
Variety just keeps on opening.
You know
up.
What? The variety did really open up. I was worried it was going to be a lot of just basic generic robots. They were like, no, Mike, we got you. Don't be alive! I don't know what I'm supposed to do there. Do you just sit on these?
I think because they're electric, you have to use wind, maybe? What was Chad saying about like the Pokemon, like rock, paper, scissors thing?
Did I dodge that? Did I just take that to the face? So you won't go here.
So it's my turn?
This kind of stuff.
That's it!
And I throw Tempest out occasionally.
Yeah, does she have an arrow move?
No.
Oh shit, really? I thought we equipped her with an arrow move. No, we didn't. Oh
yeah,
shit.
Yeah.
Damn. Machines are weak to electricity. I didn't know that was like all across the board though, chat, but. Yeah, fucking rock with some Thundara. If you got it.
Oh, we're just gonna rock that wall, huh?
Coming at you, boy. Yeah, see, it's not doing shit.
Doing 37, I can just shoot it fast.
Yeah.
Oh, don't go back there. Okay, another break. It's right on.
Do the main. Oh, yeah, never mind. Ooh.
Oh, okay. Hey now, dude, thanks for the help, bro. That was kind of crazy.
I don't think we have assess on any of these characters, chat. I'm pretty sure only Tifa and Cloud have it.
Yes. Holy
Put Arcane Whoa. Ward on Barret, then every time you'll cast Thunder, it'll cast twice. That's a good call. He made it look like that was the
Did
Arcane
Ward. You see that? I thought you could see me like thinking in my head, like, was that the move?
Yeah. Weak spot on the arm of the cannon while it's charging up.
Even if it's shielded up?
Yeah, while it was charging, yeah.
Oh my god.
I think while it's charging, it's like, it's open in that moment.
Wake up, homie. Oh shit. I don't know.
Get behind the. Yeah. You're good. Yeah. You're not good here.
I just absolutely took all of those right to the body, bro. There was no getting out of that one.
So when it charges up again, now you know to shoot the cannon. And maybe a little thunder on the cannon or some shit.
Maybe a little thunder.
There we go. It's gonna charge up.
Coming at you, okay. Is it something? 841.
Yeah, that was good.
Good.
Once you get this sucker off, though. Oh, you have to be standing in the Arcane Ward to cast twice, but also this dude puts electricity under you.
Yeah, he did that to me as well. Yeah, I'm not gonna break, though. I'm not gonna use it on that one. I'm gonna use it on this one.
Yeah. Good call. It's a great call.
I hope he hits it.
It whiffed. It hit the building.
The big guy, I think.
Oh. You
know, try to go through the big guy.
Oh.
You just keep healing me.
Yeah. She's gonna be your pocket mercy.
Yeah, be my pocket mercy. I got this.
Nice.
Okay, now we have one more to fight.
Let's shoot the gun also. Shoot the gun. Yeah, there we go.
Stand and deliver. Stand and deliver.
That's good. He took it, man. He's taking it.
He took that. Hey, Red, can you help me? I can't get an angle on this guy. Come on, buddy.
Yeah, Red, I need you, brother.
Kind of looks like Rob.
Oh,
Rob's
yeah.
Robot.
The Nintendo robot, yeah.
I don't know if I'm going to be able to. He's going to always move, huh? Should I be switching to the other person?
Yeah. Yeah, so chat said put Baird behind a rock pile, like a rubble, and then have Aerith be the... When you switch to Aerith, then it's going to focus you.
Okay.
So switch as Aerith right now, yeah. And then kind of like, yeah, get their attention away over here. It's a great call, chat. Great chats.
So
what, I don't remember.
Do I switch back and forth? Or do I
no, just keep doing this here. You're fine.
Okay.
Baird will keep doing his thing over there. But from here, you could like have Bear do a move, you know, like a fucking
yeah.
There. Yeah, like one of these focus shots. Yeah, put it on the Bear. Yeah, there you go.
That's it. Get out of there! Oh, we've lost all the dudes.
That's all right. You've got another rock pile. You can work it back there. Or you can also get behind the pillars and shit.
Run for your life, lady!
Oh my god.
Dude. You don't have a dive button?
It's just this. Oh, I think that's the Arcane Ward, that flower thing.
Yeah, interesting. Okay, so that was the Arcane Ward. Okay. Get over there, homie.
I'll take care of them. Get him!
I love this.
Need more magic.
There we go. Now I'm gonna do this. Check this out. Don't worry about it.
We got an ether. Fuck with your soul like ether. You don't have any mega ether.
This one.
I have a problem with you. I just didn't scroll far enough, I bet.
No, they're usually right below that, I believe. So maybe not.
Ha!
Hell yeah, shoot Tora.
Here it comes.
Oh my god.
Gotta dig deep for this one.
As you're watching my pop off, I want to thank RG Triple for 9 months of Prime Gaming. Thank you, RG Triple. Dark Knight, 26 months of support. All the Rage, Casper, resubscribing. Oi!
Aired, homie, this is a tough fight. This is like a long fight.
Yeah, no, it's a long one. On normal, it took fucking forever. And the worst is like they take so long, and then when you lose, it's like gotta do it all over again. Why does he only have two abilities? Because Mike is just we've been playing on easy.
We've been playing on easy. You gotta remember.
Yeah, they're having.
You gotta remember where you've been.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah. Okay. You gotta remember where you've been. I don't know what that means.
Here.
I need you to focus steel shot this barrier drone. I don't know if he's aiming at it if he's back there, you know? He's popping out of it, yeah.
I think so.
I hit that weak spot.
Good chance.
Tagging out. Watch and
learn. Homie, I need this is not fun. This is like an awkward fight of like it's just not positioned well.
Yeah.
To be super enjoyable here.
You just gotta wait for Barret. I think you continue controlling Barret instead of Aerith. Just to build up your limit, and then you switch to her, and then have him limit break the fucking thing. Because that's the only way you're gonna build up your limit is by doing shit. Is otherwise his limit's gonna fucking take forever to build up. Got stunned. Oh god. I was gonna take this.
Yep. You saw it cut in slow mo.
You just nothing you can do about it.
It's not happening.
Straight into it.
Right in front of me.
Oh yeah, the weak spot's also the back. Yeah, while his cards been doing that shit.
I need Barret to do on the barrier jump, please.
But also, like, his limit's getting building up since you've been using him. Yeah, just keep using Barret, build up that limit break, switch to Aerith, and then he'll have a clear shot of the barrier drone. And you fire in the hole, that shit. They're very sturdy pillars.
Thank God.
Nice, getting some crits right there. It's beautiful.
Come in.
Tagging out.
Oh yeah, dog. Oh yeah. You're so close to limit, dude. You're pushing it to the limit.
On the weak spot. Fucking buckle up, going for it.
Oh, nice, dude.
A little behind, but it was close.
That was good. You didn't even get hit.
And that limit break. There it is.
So it's my turn?
Hell yes.
There we go.
Now set it and forget
Barret,
it.
Hit me, baby. I don't think Barret hit it. Oh,
dude. Now, no shield.
Now we fuck this thing up.
No shield. Fucking go in raw. I could probably use more ether now.
It's your turn. About damn time.
Big
Focus the wheels if you can't break down them wheels. But use like thunder on the wheels and shit too. Oh yeah. Oh, you're getting that weakness down. Keep focusing that shit.
Oh, crazy.
Get out of there.
Oh, God.
Nice.
Fire in one off.
Go away. Stop on this.
Gotta love that.
We're just gonna get touched by that.
That's okay. Don't worry. It's all right. It is what it is.
She got the super healing.
Yeah. That's gotta feel good to get hit with.
This is fantastic.
So what are we doing, dude? What are we doing?
Staying alive.
Holy shit, I'm alive.
You're in a, now you're just stuck in there now, though. After this, hit me with a thunder on like the main body. See how much damage we get out of it. Oh, you're out of MP though, bro.
Say your prayers and beg for forgiveness.
And have Aaron kill your bitch ass. Not enough. I think the wheels gotta be focused. I know you've been doing the right wheel, the rear one, but it's like harder to do that when it's always facing you.
Exactly.
I think you focus that that right front wheel from now on. Fuck the rear one. I know it's weak, but it's gonna take forever to get around to it. And the attention's always going to be on you because you're the one controlling Barrett. Yeah, fuck it. You got to tank it.
One gun arm versus another gun arm.
Got to tank it.
Two boys.
Mono y mono.
Yep. You got me.
Dude, this thing can't have that much health.
Oh my god, you barely hurt it.
Well, once we take down the wheels, that's when, like, cause that weak spot in the back, like, you're supposed to kind of, that weak, the little plate in the back is where a lot of the crit gets taken place, I believe.
Shoot him for a little bit. Let me use the rest. I don't think anything will happen while I'm gone.
Oh, he's about to get.
Feel confident in that one.
Can you, yeah, heal him?
Yeah, for sure.
I'll take care of you.
We gotta get out of this fucking wall of fire death.
We gotta beat this game.
Here it comes. Yoo-hoo! That's it.
Mal 9000 says, forget the wheels.
One more shot.
Huh? How do I lock onto like the main body in the back?
Cut! Can you take over for me?
Main cannon's still the weak spot. I want to try to get around over here.
Oh, you got one of his wheels, right?
Yeah, we fucked up real good.
Oh, wow.
Oh. Now we're losing pillars.
Yeah, so much for that pillar strength. Naughty Biscotti says, use Tempest. Way stronger than you think.
Oh.
It seems like an opinion.
Let's do a little. Damn, I wish Aerith had more spells. We gotta give her.
Gotta get more TMs in her.
Yeah, man, she has no fucking abilities, man.
You've got this.
Oh, I was like, what happened? But he's looking. He's pointing at me now.
Uh-oh. Yeah, there you go. The pillar will protect. Praise it.
Watch and learn. Oh, here we go. Focus shot on the laser cannon. Mm-hmm. We're popping off, man.
You make great progress.
You feel it in your knees?
I guess I haven't sat on the couch
sitting.
For a long
I'm
time.
I'm sitting, you're feeling it in your knees.
We're sitting in a weird position, right?
No, I feel you.
Me and Andy aren't laying back like this. Like, you see, we're fucking.
You could.
Here, I feel you, bro.
Know what I mean?
You could lay back.
We're like up here, straight up, trying to look professional, you know what I mean?
Nailing it.
Thanks. Thanks, Kev. Haven't had that lounge fit vibe yet.
Don't catch a cold.
Cut. Is that one attack called foreskin? That's what I saw too. Whoa.
No, it's a
foreskin.
Can you take over for me?
It's the one where you get like super powerful, fortify.
Oh,
or some shit.
Terrifying.
Like you get a health. It's like a shield almost. You take a lot of damage.
Oh, there you go. You took out two of the wheels.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Still, you got this.
I'll take care of them. You've got this. Yeah. Here goes.
I just don't know how to. I'm still struggling with like not focusing the wheels. Threat level maximum. Oh shit.
Try havoc.
Maybe hide behind the air.
Doesn't look good.
Any ideas?
Take cover behind the bridge.
That thing's about to blow up, bro.
Woohoo!
Oh my shit. God, it still blew up. That's crazy. I guess we gotta win now.
We can't hide.
What do we do?
Stop
this
attack.
Fuck you.
That's why he's the best.
Fuck you.
Office, man. He's the best.
Click R3 to lock. Move the target with right stick. It didn't. I don't know. It didn't feel like it was working, but I probably wasn't doing it right.
Cloud and Tifa could be dead already. It's so weird.
What a weird shot.
Yeah.
Why is Lion talking to us like this? All escape
and quick. Real. It's the real deal.
You're right. Let's go.
Hand up, stretch.
I'm gonna go pee real quick.
Stretch your legs.
I don't know, I'm just lying.
Just a big cat.
I might be a wolf.
Could be a dog. We have the building surrounded. You got one eyeball?
No.
You got two eyes?
I think so.
Why?
Crazy, you take out two giant pillars. Building totally fine.
Totally fine. No structural damage.
There's no smoke in here.
No fire.
You
no,
think nothing. There'd be a little bit of smoke.
All we gotta do now is find the others.
I think we gotta get out, bro. We gotta get out.
Get out.
Who's next to be introduced? Oh, it's Big H.
Heroin himself.
We have them surrounded, sir.
Yes, I can see that. It was only a matter of time. Here we are. So then, what is this ragtag group of misfits I see before me? Avalanche!
Local florist!
Lab rat dog.
Oh! That one's actually pretty good.
And yeah. Where are the rest of you? Up your ass. Charming, though not what I would have chosen as my last words. Secure the ancient, but feel free to kill both the idiot and the dog.
Uh-oh.
Aerith, you saved La Marlene. No. It's time.
Oh my.
Wait.
Well, they just said they weren't gonna kill her, you know?
I feel something. The disturbance in the force. You hear it. You hear it, Kev. Oh, it's fucking Cloud! Oh my god, bro!
God, he just fucking.
Holy cow, dude! Oh man, that's so sick!
Is that the motorcycle from the lobby?
Dude! He's ripping it up! If he grabs this girl, puts her on the back of the motorcycle, and dips out, it's gonna be the craziest thing on earth. Look at this! I gotta get my motorcycle license ASAP. She's in the mini Tonka truck!
Mini Tonka truck.
Get in the truck! Okay, well, someone's gotta get on the back of the motorcycle. We can't on the car, son.
Stop them, you fools! Don't let them
drive escape. Right over this guy.
His sword look really short right there.
It looks real short, but it's so freaking cool! He's gonna drive right through him! Oh! No, he didn't! Oh! Are you kidding me?
Let's roll. Okay.
That's the best scene in the video game! Oh my god! They're going up the stairs! What are they doing?
Take the elevator!
Where are we going? Oh, we're just out. Oh, dude, drop the gun and run.
Yeah.
Oh. They chucked a sword at him! Oh my god, dude, are you kidding me?
He missed.
He did what you've always wanted to do.
He chucked the sword right out of Andy!
Oh, that's cool.
What are we doing? It's a masterpiece.
I've heard you say about 30 times this whole playthrough, throw the fucking sword at him. He finally did it.
He hunked that sword, dude, so cool. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is the end of Final Fantasy VII Remake.
Yeah.
Incredible video game. You can't go anywhere from there.
You can't.
That's how you have to end the video game.
You're getting real close, dude.
Really? Oh, not there yet, huh?
I wouldn't celebrate just yet.
Man, you need to lighten up.
No.
Hell, you might even try smiling.
Look, just one eye, you're right.
That's the cutest smile around, bro.
On second thought, maybe
I'm gonna buy myself a panther one day. I'm gonna have a panther dog.
Look.
Now, if some random two ladies break into your house and steal the panther, are you gonna let them steal it? Like you let them steal your cats?
Simba. Simba. Had to go.
People stole your cats?
Yeah, I'm like that.
Two random women broke into his apartment, into his house. He saw these random women stealing his cats. He was like, that's what it's gotta be.
There's no Ezio real story.
That's the happening.
You just gotta let things happen. There were no whispers getting in the way. You're like, they'd stop that if that was meant to be, you know? Let nature run its course.
What's happening here, bro? And we went from like three whispers to start the game to about a billion here.
I think there was a lot more than three at the beginning.
This is the sexy good dude. No, he's not the sexy good dude. That's a different dude.
Oh, dude, looks like a night elf I'd create in WoW.
Yes, exactly. Sexy, tall, beautiful hair.
Oh, Sang, yeah, okay.
Is something wrong, sir?
Oh, he's not vibing? What's wrong?
Like, hey, dude, your dad's not okay.
Yeah.
Oh, the dad's dead. But it's a new era of Shinra. He doesn't care about his dad.
I'm the president now.
Never cared about him. Go make Neo Midgar.
I see. Very good.
Mike was talking about Reeve, Andy.
No, rev the car. Standby, sir.
Your orders.
Red line. Take it to the red line.
Bring them in.
Oh, okay.
I think it's an hour or so left.
It's like the whole damn building's made of them.
Maybe it's less because we're playing on easy.
I don't understand. What are they doing?
You got a recording to do.
Yeah, well, I have the plan.
Yeah?
Wait.
I got the plan.
You don't think he got caught up in it, do you?
If he did, I hope he's okay.
They're coming.
Who?
Oh man, dude. Oh man. I mean, what else could we do in this game? It's time to get run out of town, right? Who do we have to go back for? Marlene? Wedge is dead.
Is he?
Yeah, we don't know what happened to Wedge.
He didn't look dead.
No, Wedge isn't dead.
Yeah, all right.
he was trying to save his friends, and Destiny stopped him, and he was like...
Wait, you just went back to Sector 5 slums with the mom? Why is his music so
good?
Oh. Can you imagine that movie playing like, you let him get away. He sliced my motorcycle.
Yeah.
Dude, what a drift, man.
So cool, bro. Let's all get our motorcycle license.
I don't know. Mike, you cannot see.
Come on, like, got a motorcycle.
There's no windshield. It's easier to see.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is how it has to go, unfortunately. We have to record WWE in review right now at 2 o'clock. But here's what we're going to do. We're beating this game no matter what. So I will make a secondary record with Bear right now. We will come back after that, finish the game. I know we have a lot of things going on, but that will be the plan. We'll just solo queue this. We got to finish it.
Wait, Twitch stream it or?
Twitch stream and YouTube. I'll tell Bear to make a new
All
YouTube
right
now. Chat, that has been part 1.2 of our finale gameplay. We'll be back in about an hour for more of this. See you soon.